the freestyle by Corey Holcomb and this bitch. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Ever since I saw the little hoe, niggas knocking on my motherfucking door. Is Trina there? Is she coming out? I say, hey, put that thing in that bitch mouth. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. Going in my refrigerator. Every nigga that nut in her, somehow they hate her.
Oh.
Her two kids that she kept cause she thought them dudes was gonna give her fuck. But then they ducked out on her ass. Fuck that silly slut. Even though that bitch do got a big ass butt. But I won't fuck her though. Cause it's your daughter. But get the daughter out my face before the slaughter. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
I told you he had some shit.
Cool. What up? We on, motherfucker? Alright. Yeah, I got on my Freddy Krueger side of the game hat. Nigga, all the real niggas, this is Bosalino, so you know what that is. Most motherfuckers don't even know what that is. I'm just saying. Bosalino, I fuck with that 100 shit. Anyway, what up, motherfuckers? The 5150 lives, Freeze Love, got caught up in traffic.
I did too, but I just walked in here.
Darlene just wanted to let it be known that she made it before Freeze.
You know what? I'm just saying it's bad out there right now. I'm just agreeing.
It's
yeah.
fucked up out there.
All right. Leave about an hour and a half before and you still don't make it here. LA is
What's
terrible.
Up, D?
What's up, Corey?
Yeah, goddamn it. Bebe strolling her little ass in here.
Hey.
Telling motherfuckers she coming from the gym and shit.
No, but I had four classes today. I usually have three. I had four. And I was hella tired. And I just be going home. A lot of times people always ask me about my hair. Why I put it up. Why don't I ever do it? What is your problem?
What? I don't believe you be having gym classes. You be coming from some you don't... nigga house.
Oh, yes. That's why I'm all worked out, worked up, yeah. red face. Yeah.
A little flush.
Right.
No.
Getting jaw reps in. Got this.
No.
What happened to the little bullshit ass shit you created? The punch, Chris. Normally when I say little, something, you press that little bullshit.
Oh, he don't want it. He's so sweet.
He only
he
do
don't
it on the ones
that.
He won't do.
Yeah.
Right.
It get annoying anyway, so fuck it.
Looking out Bruh. For me, looking out for me, Chris.
Chris over there with the Apple computer with the melted keypads on that bitch.
Stop, I can't.
You did.
That's Chris's Freeze made it.
My nigga Freeze, Freeze Love in the motherfucking house. We was telling everybody how that traffic what's fucked up out there. You right, baby?
What's up, mister?
What's up? Yeah.
All right.
Chris, I got a task for you.
Uh-oh.
And I say this to all my 5150 people. That last Friday in what is it, January? I'm doing my DVD.
Oh shit!
So I'm about to try some clever shit, cause I know motherfuckers got love. So I'm needing y'all, motherfucker, you computer slick niggas, to make a flyer. Corey Holcomb filming his DVD.
Uh-oh.
Boston at the Wilbur Theater.
Woo! Yeah, yeah.
God
get
damn it.
Get your chowder.
Right. Friday, January 29th, I believe that is. I hope I got that date right. Friday, January 29th. I'm going to film my DVD.
Oh, it's going to be crazy.
Freeze going to host the motherfucker. We got Crazy Carmen as the motherfucking middle act. And
where's it happening at?
It's at Boston at the Wilbur Theater.
Oh.
And I asked the nation to... You know, oh yeah, cause it's some clever motherfuckers, niggas like Gucci and all the motherfuckers.
Yep.
They be making flyers and shit. You know what I'm
Gucci's a genius at that Gucci. Shit.
Right. Yeah, it's
that's
other
the
motherfuckers
meme
we forgetting. Oh, it's God. Other motherfuckers we forgetting. We just remember Gucci the most because we see him all the time.
Right.
And your name is easy to remember, Gucci.
Gucci the Great.
Gucci the Great is easy to remember.
God damn it, niggas sitting around the crib with $100,000 on the couch.
Yeah.
More than that, really. I'm just saying, my nigga. All you bitches who starving, goddamn it, see if that nigga pity you. My nigga, though. Be pitied. Nah, but I want this shit to be big, man. This shit at the Wilbur Theater on the 29th.
That's a dope
theater. I'm promoting it now. You know, I haven't had a DVD since Your Way Ain't Working.
Uh-oh. Ooh.
Because what happens out here, and I want to say this, you know, what happens, you get in bed with these companies and shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And they pay to have your DVD done. And then before you know it, they got slick shit in the contract where you fucked over. It was this company called Cold Black. They fucked me over real good. Oh, fuck niggas. They fucked over a lot of niggas too.
Ooh, they fucked me over lovely.
They fucked niggas.
They got me lovely.
Fuck niggas.
You wow. got me lovely.
Well, how, right. get, how do they get? How do they get you guys multiple times?
This is what happens.
Well, they got me once.
Oh, okay, yeah? Okay.
Give me once, goddamn it.
Well, a lot of entertainers, once. What you do is you look for an outlet in the rap game, in the music game, even the comedy game. Some motherfucker come to you with some money. Mm-hmm. And you be like, fuck it, I want this money.
Right.
But then later on, you realize, God damn, I should have bet on myself. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Well, that's what happened with me. So it ain't all they fault. I fucked myself too. But they had bad intent. Fuck niggas have bad intentions. Companies have bad intentions by you. So Corey Holcomb is digging into the bank with whatever it costs to get this shit done. Because it costs a lot of money to put a production like that together.
Yeah.
But I'm banking on myself. I'm betting on myself because I know it's gonna be something different.
So we get if we get our own tickets to fly out there, we can attend it.
Of
You'll
course.
Let us all in.
Yeah. Come on now, we're
gonna God support the brother.
Okay,
I got
good.
I got some different shit going on with this DVD. This ain't no regular nigga just on stage walking around shit. You know what I'm saying?
I can't
reveal it all, but this gonna be some different shit. God damn it, y'all saw the last one I did where I had. The little bar and shit, like it was like,
oh,
yeah. You know what I'm saying?
A little loungy. Uh-huh.
I'm about to take this shit to a whole nother level.
Yeah, tavern set up.
A little tavern and shit. So, yeah, I'm putting it out there because, you know what I'm saying? It's like, hey, I need some help promoting this. We doing two shows, and I need both of them to be sold out. The theater ain't that big.
So, New York, Boston, everybody in that area, tri-state Jersey, area, Jersey, Delaware, all
yeah.
that. Get over there
and
max it out.
Let's do this shit, man. I'm trying to get this shit cracking so I can motherfucking be in them awkward parties and shit with the moist niggas. I don't be in none of the parties no more because, you know what I'm saying?
Well, just have your own party then.
Them awkward parties like Kat said, you know I can see you. Remember what Kat said? That's it. I call them awkward parties.
Yeah.
I want to start attending these awkward parties and shit. Hope
What's
I
one of them awkward parties? That nigga Bokeem Woodbine stole
Oh, wait. What?
He stole your hat?
Yeah.
See, that's an awkward party.
Exactly.
Wait,
that's
off your off
that's
your
a
head?
Strange ass party to be at.
What, you laid your hat down?
No. Who's it?
Did the nigga gangster your hat, man?
I had a bomb ass.
Oh.
Fly, proper AC Deucey. Chris, black, stingy brim, lovely.
So he just stole
lovely.
Your shit.
He says, you know, I mean, yo, that hat is really nice. Let me check it out, freeze. And grabbed it.
No.
Kind of like I did you that day, but.
Stop.
But not like
when you
that.
When you exposed the shark fin.
It wasn't a shark fin. What it was is he took the hat and put it on and took off.
But he was for real. He
yeah,
took off.
It was in the club. I'm like, hey.
Is that nigga gone?
My hat on his head.
So he stole the cat and jumped in the
He got
in
the crowd. Hey, out of the way. Hey, nice to meet you. Look at me. Oh, really?
You my man, Freeze, but where I'm from, they don't say
that was
he
it.
Yo,
he gangstered your hat, dog.
He got away. Mm-hmm.
You got punked.
You understand? Man, I ain't getting punked, nigga.
He gangstered your hat, dog. He gangstered
well,
your hat,
punch man.
Well,
punch for your hat, Freeze.
Okay.
That nigga, look at that nigga. That nigga eyes got
wait.
I'm not used to being around a grimy motherfucker that would steal a hat off of a man's head.
Freeze got Debo'd.
No, Debo's your dude. They didn't stay there and say, now I'm wearing your hat.
I was
no,
gonna say, look, I was gonna
he
say,
put
like,
him, he put
y'all
my
were
hat.
Putting it nicely. So y'all were putting it cool.
He fled. You understand?
He fled.
Right.
He fled. He left the
yo,
scene.
Yo, man, bring
quickly.
My nigga Freeze hat.
I didn't chase him. Who am I gonna look like? Hey, come
right.
back with my hat.
Right.
No, I didn't do none of that. I just was like, oh, he got my hat. Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah. Giving it to
yo. This nigga with one
hell of a fun.
Yo. That rascally rabbit took my hat.
Mexican Elmer Fudd.
Mexican Elmer Fudd.
See, I'm Mexican, Dominican, Puerto Rican.
Yeah, they don't know what to think of you.
Hey, he got you though.
He got me, but
either that nigga gotta give you a hat.
Wait, you gotta hear the
wait, though, but when did it happen? How long is it?
Now he's gonna tell us how he redeemed
himself. It's statute of limitations, he said.
He was having fun drinking with my hat way across the room.
Oh, he didn't leave.
He had his holding drink up.
Oh, my God.
I see you, nigga.
I let him get good and
saucy. He got to stumbling around. He forgot that the hat wasn't his.
Right.
He wandered his ass back around my way. And that's when I gave him the good old arm around his shoulder counseling.
Right.
About taking these hats.
Right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. You understand? All right.
He says, I never meant to disrespect you.
Right.
I was just having fun free.
Right. Whatever, Bo King Woodbine. Do you remember Bo King Woodbine from Dead President?
Yeah.
He was in the latest Riddick movie.
I was going to say, you can't forget him. He's
that's
a character.
Bo King, he gets it in.
Yeah.
He gets it in.
He said...
Give me the gun. I'm going to show you who's boss.
Yeah,
he's the dead president.
Yo, that's how he did. He was out the same way in Dead Presidents.
Yeah.
It's a church. I'll get the money.
And then Jason's lyric, he got that look. Oh, he be like,
right.
That I'm fucked up on camera look.
Right. He was good with that.
Well, you can't get right.
He got me again. You know what? I actually meeting Bo King got me because he told me when I first met him he was a member of Onyx.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I'm a member of Onyx. I'm the sixth member. We had like 10 members, and I was the one that decided to go into acting.
No.
He wasn't a member of Onyx?
Not that I know. No.
See, but you know what? Unbelievable.
I think he's saying it because he knows he kind of ain't in the face and then like they just.
That one little nigga from Onyx.
Fredro Starr.
Yeah, Fredro.
Yeah, the nigga who be in the movies.
With the wandering eye.
Loped out. Yeah. Oh, no. Wait a minute.
Sticky fingers.
Wait a minute, because the one with the eye, I seen him on Hollywood Boulevard.
That's
you know that nigga when you see him because that nigga, yo, Corey, what? I was like, that's that nigga right there. What up, Joe? I see them on Hollywood Boulevard. What's the little bitty nigga name?
Fredro that's Fredro. Star. He's a little tiny one.
Yeah.
He's got a narrow. Right. Yeah, he's really little.
Yeah. Niggas was shooting some scene in a movie. They had to put some books on them because the bitches was taller than them.
Oh,
shit. I ain't trying to diss him. I'm just saying, I thought that was funny when I heard about that shit. Because, you know, on the camera, it looked like he was acting tough with the bitches, but he was like, hey, you bitches. They was like, cut.
Hey, you
to put the books up there.
They gave him a couple of feet. That's funny.
Yeah. Darlene said the wondering eye though. But anyway, that's what.
I want to know. We got to give Darlene some props for her book.
Thank you.
There was an article written about her book in the New York Times.
New York Times.
That's big time.
I got
to give her props.
I'm still cheesing. My face hurts. I'm so excited.
That's what's up.
These motherfuckers sleep on D. Goddammit.
I'm excited
to come out with that next book, The Cleanup Woman.
Well, we're optioning the book right now. So we're already getting our offers for optioning. If you know what that means.
Yeah, that's when you put an option on the book. But look at what I'm trying to say.
It's for a screenplay, Corey. It's
I know.
All right. Well, stop. You don't know if they know or not. I'm just. No, you
that's
do.
When they put an option on the book.
Yeah, you have
an option to do this or an option to do that.
Right.
That ain't hard to figure out. It's an option on that motherfucker.
Right. Well, maybe I'll find my farmer quicker.
Oh, shit. What crazy shit we forget? We should leave that for D.
What?
Leave that for D.
Oh, hey. Yeah. I don't know what you want to bring up, but I've got. Oh, God.
But wait, Fred.
Right. Huh?
Hey. But you want to shout out some of the real cats out there.
Do you want to do it now or later? Truth,
well, right? that's we're going to topic that.
Okay.
Come with after
DC. Yeah, there you go.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? I know that, look. I want to say this about Stephen A. Smith. I saw him.
You lie.
He done went in on some people.
He done went in, but then.
Wait, this, you saw
something
him
he said today. Something he said today really stuck with me.
Mm-hmm.
Because it lets me know, like, some people mentality. Because they was talking about, you know, Nick Saban won his fifth
championship.
Mm-hmm.
College National. Football niggas play for free title. And I'm saying, I heard him say something where he was making points about Bear Bryant. And he said, Bear Bryant, I'm not taking nothing away from him. He was making points for Saban and making points for Bear Bryant.
Right.
And then he said that Bear Bryant gave blacks an opportunity to play. I got to give him props for that. And I was so mad when he said that. Not mad at him. It's just it let me know the mentality he has. Mm. Bear Bryant had to give blacks the opportunity to play so he can compete.
Because
he played USC down here in California.
Who had all
they
the
had them fast niggas.
Don't forget.
And famous bottom line, if you're going to compete in all these physical sports, you got to have them niggas.
Right.
So you didn't give motherfuckers an opportunity. You had to get some niggas if you wanted to compete with the schools who got real talent.
And you can't put Bear Bryant on the same pedestal as, say, an Al Davis for the Raiders, who was the first to bring brothers in.
Mm-hmm.
Al Davis made sure brothers ate with the Raiders.
Mm.
Brothers who nobody else wanted to touch. Mm. That's why the Raiders have this aura of, you know, the bad boys come to the Raiders, and you know, they took a chance on a gang of brothers. So you can't put Bear Bryant.
You just turned me into a Raiders fan.
Oh, for real? Yeah. Al Davis was y'all come
Al
here.
Davis used to fuck with the niggas, right?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Y'all come here.
Yeah.
Nobody else want to fuck with you? Come over here.
Come fuck
so,
with me.
By no stretch fuck of the imagination you know, was Bear Bryant and Al
anywhere
Davis.
Near it, right?
Right.
No.
I caught that right away as soon as he said he gave blacks an opportunity. He didn't get nobody shit. When them motherfuckers need you, they come find you.
Right.
They
I'm
got
tired
motherfuckers.
Of losing. God damn it. We got to get some fucking niggers, man.
Right?
Okay,
right. Listen.
Look, this
listen,
the meeting room. This the NFL meeting room.
Now listen here. There. We could go up the middle. We could do button hooks, Statue of Liberties. We can do the fight. We can do tricky handoffs. We can do all that. Well, until we get some goddamn niggers on our fucking squad, we're going to get our asses kicked. Now, I'm going to be the first to admit it. Hell, they're faster than us. They're more athletic. Goddamn, they're hung like Clydesdales. And some of you may lose your fucking wives and gals, but damn it, that's the sacrifice you're going to make. It's time we win, goddamn it. So I say, let's go pick us a nigger and let's win.
That's right.
Pick us
all right, coach, let's go. Let's go to the hood and draft our
hell
future.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, let's go. Hell, throw them in jail. Are you crazy? That's millions of dollars.
Oh.
Send them this way. We give them an education and a Cadillac and send them on their way.
They need to do a documentary on how the niggers change football. Back in the day, we were competing for titles with Jimmy off the field and from the farm.
Here's a little known fact. You ever wonder why all the other basketball, what else, softball, golf, everything else is round?
Yeah.
But football is very specific in its shape.
Yes, sir.
Some might say it resembles a watermelon.
Right.
You understand here? You understand? I Bear Bryant say, hell, they're naturals. Right. Give it to them. Give them. Let's bring them in here. Let's make some money off these coons, man.
Look, this Bear Bryant in practice. All you got to do is run with the brown watermelon. You got
to do, Rufus. Come here, you and Leroy. Come here. Let's see which one of you is bigger.
Right.
All right. Now,
come here, Dwight.
Darnell, Shavante, y'all come on over here. Shaquem, Raheem, Shaw.
Right.
Shaw, that's what they call you.
Shaw Mecca. Come on
over here.
Stop.
Bubba B.
Bubba B.
Oh, God.
Kenny.
Kenny.
Oh, God.
Hey, okay. You and Chavez line up right over there.
Chavez. One made it in there.
You're goddamn right. Hell, if we're bringing in the niggas, let's bring in the wetbacks. Let's get out some damn cowboys, some warlords. We're going to need all that.
We're going to have the best goddamn lawn out there for them niggas to run up.
I'll tell you what, let's bring in some goddamn Asians so we can get some goddamn hell of a good plays. How about that?
Right.
Huh? Some scientific shit on these sons of bitches.
Get these boys some rice in the system.
Oh, my God. So up some good uniforms.
Right.
Some
you want to get your nails done?
You got some good coon ball down here, goddamn it.
Let's get us some good Indian food up in here, too. Fuck all these hamburgers. I want some shawarma.
Get some of them in here. We need some motherfucker to build a fire over here. Ooh.
Oh, damn it.
Get him down here to Alabama University.
Goddamn right. And hey, you're going to have to do legal shit. Let's get us some Italians so we can get some of that red tape cut, too. Make it happen, Captain. I'm goddamn right. I know how to win, sons of bitches. Get in line.
Snack Fu said, get them niggas some grits on that field. Yeah. Grits and watermelon juice.
You want to win, don't you?
Right.
The white girls. Gotta give them white girls.
Oh, now
you're taking it a little too far now. Yeah. We'll come hang the whole motherfucking village.
Now we see why you're not in charge. Though. Right. Assistant Coach Zoe Williams. You see how they try to sneak up it in there and get them some white girls. That's not going to happen.
Because next thing you know, Zoe's going to sound like homeboy. What homework. Was the politician that said something and they impregnate all of white women? Remember?
Who said that?
Recently, and he just backed off and said that it was, I didn't mean to say that. He clearly said
black
it.
Black and white.
He's white, dude.
Well, they say a lot of fucked up shit, but anyway.
Oh, God, that's too funny.
All right, fuck it, let's get it in. We're going to get Darlene's subject. This is the subject known across the nation as Darlene's Loose Talk About Bullshit.
Put your Z's together. Just set her up lovely right now.
Set me up good? All right. Anyway, so let's go in. Let's go right into it.
Cornbread hot fudge.
A lot of folks are talking about El Chapo. Joaquin El Chapo Guzman. That's his proper full name.
Joaquin El Chapo Guzman.
Right. And some say Shorty because El Chapo stands for Shorty. So some say Joaquin El Chapo Shorty Guzman. Anyway, he was captured in Sinaloa, Mexico, is his hometown. It's funny about that. So anyway, he was captured there on Friday. And it lasted a good shootout. As a matter of fact, if you go online, you can actually see the whole thing. It was with Mexican... Marines. Well, yeah, that too.
They got Mexican Marines.
Law enforcement. as they were doing the fight, as they were fighting, right, the whole shootout, and you can see it, El Chapo was attempting to escape through, again, a secret passage in the home this time that descended into a tunnel leading to the city's storm drains. But
you can only do that once,
got stuck.
They told him about it. They told him, like, on 300, the little hunchback Mexican motherfucker. El Chapo! You won't let me fight in the army!
That's why, if you go online at CNN, they have one of the best walkthroughs, because it's the same dude that did the walkthrough when he escaped from the prison. It's the same guy on CNN that is doing the walkthrough on this one at the house the next day, right? And the storm drain, and the bottom, it's like flooded. So you have to actually go under this thing to swim. And the guy, anyway, that's why, if you've seen the captured footage, the photo I gave you of El Chapo, he comes out, he's messed up. He's got a tore up, messed up wife beater on that is all filthy dirty because he had to go like underwater to try and get over this little hump, right? They bring him out like 5 hours later. Wait, though. The best meme, by the way, I just have to say it, is one that makes reference to his thing. And they said, look, he's sporting the new Weezy $2,000 tank top. Yeezy. couldn't.
I'll say this about El Chapo and all them guys. Like, I remember the other day you did a story on Suge Knight.
Because I'm going to talk about, go ahead, but I'm going to talk about what they
I'm
think
hesitant
he's got
to
him
talk
caught.
About the streets, because I still be in the streets.
No,
I don't want to see El Chapo.
He's going to be fine.
Funny man.
See El Chapo with Suge Knight.
Right. Yeah. Oh, hey, funny fella.
Remember
anyway.
That shit you said?
No, we're not making fun of the fact that he was caught or anything. I'm just talking about, like, that tank top comment.
They'll be like, chop up the pork roast over here.
It's Bobby's tank top. Stop it. Did you just say that, Chris?
What did he say?
It's Bobby's tank top.
Yeah, that is Bobby tank top.
El Chapo got on Bobby's tank top.
Okay, anyway, so they a lot
El
of people
Chapo tank top cleaner. Go ahead.
You're so...
It don't smell like smoke. Stop. We love you, Bobby. We fucking with
we
you.
We do. Anyway, a lot of folks are saying
No.
You know what? A lot of folks are speculating that the reason he was caught is because of his communication with Sean Penn. The actor, he was reached out to by an actress, a Mexican actress, very popular. Her name's Kate Del Castillo. And she's been
Kate Del Castillo?
Oh, shut up, Corey, whatever. And she's the one, the middle person who connected them because he reached out to her, El Chapo did, for her to get in touch with Sean Penn. So if you haven't seen it, they met. Anyway, a funny thing is about this, the interview anyway on Rolling Stone aired on Saturday. So if you guys want to look it up, it's very interesting.
Him and Sean Penn?
Yeah, he interviewed him. Stop. The reason why they were meeting since October, they've been meeting. The first meeting happened, and he said he couldn't do another interview because they were feeling the heat. He had gotten a couple of homes broken into, busted into. They were looking for him. So he denied the second meeting. Well, the second one is this one that happened. They kept pushing him, and he ended up doing the second meeting, and then that's when it happened. They said that the communication between all the actors and the producers and the magazine are the ones that ended up, they're speculating, getting him busted because of the feeds. Like, they were catching the feeds. Anyway, the guy, if you see the shirt, the funniest thing about the whole thing, if you watch the interview, it's really good, though, by the way. So they got enough work, they got enough information from him to do a life story. So apparently Sean's going to maybe produce this or do the story on him. But it's funny, the guy, the
Didn't
shirt.
Sean Penn play in Colors?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was the cop.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
He was the rookie.
Yeah.
The rookie cop.
Mm-hmm. Pac-Man. They called him Pac-Man.
Pac-Man. That was
Pac-Man.
Fuck you, Pac-Man.
No, that was not me, but that was funny when she told him, when she got busted sleeping with the brother and she was putting her top back on.
Can we just address the elephant in the room about this story? I just believe there are some actors who are a part of the CIA. I believe that's what Hollywood is about. They present a narrative in the films. Because my question is, how the fuck does Sean Penn connect with a fucking drug lord?
Well, if you read about their way to meet him, it was pretty deep. So it wasn't easy.
You understand what I'm saying?
You looked it up through Creasy.
Creasy. I'm just saying, like, to me, like, normal motherfuckers don't.
Well, look, this is what you have to realize, though.
That shit's crazy.
Out here in Hollywood, Hollywood is connected to the feds.
Like a motherfucker. It ain't.
When that shit went down with them Twin Towers, that was back when I was fucking with them motherfuckers.
That was movie making.
The feds came down here and they had a talk with Hollywood. And have you noticed there hasn't been spinoff ideas about what really happened?
Yeah, you see what I'm saying?
They're not allowed to talk about what happened with 9/11 because common sense says bullshit you said on TV didn't happen. It ain't happened like that.
Right.
And they don't want people to have other ideas about what happened.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's why a lot of movies are not made about what people think happened.
Right.
Fucking plane knocked down a fucking building.
Because somebody like
building.
A Michael
get
Moore, somebody like
here.
A Michael Moore is going to get shut down.
That
like
was
he
specifically
just,
built to resist a plane knocking it down.
And both of them fail like that.
Come on,
who's fucking stupid? Sorry. This is what Hollywood's about. Man. Hollywood's not allowed to do those type of movies.
Right.
But they're allowed to make you think Stryker coming to save you. Stryker, they killed his daughter. He's coming for them.
Right. You know.
Stryker.
Shit.
Some punk ass,
right.
Coy ass actor, goddammit, with a suit on looking tough. Right. I'm gonna fucking kill you. After
I think
I
the
fuck
real
the
movie.
Shit out of this motherfucker.
I think the real movie.
He strikes him.
Is the news, is politics. That's the real Hollywood. Those are the real actors.
Mm-hmm.
But it looked real because we are in this movie with them.
That's we have no choice. We don't. How are we gonna know? Right. They're giving us, they're the feed.
That's what I think.
Anyway,
save me, Stryker.
Anyway,
I'm coming to get you.
If you want the shirt that Chapo has on in that photo, it is now sold out. Isn't that crazy how people are? But the guy's posing in the, I put that up to his shop. He's like, yeah, it's sold out.
What Chapo shirt?
It's in Mexico. It's a store, but it's this guy, and he's like, I can get you one online. But anyway, the shirt that he had on with Sean Penn, look, there's the guy that made it. It's sold out. He's like, yeah, he's happy camper.
Oh, yeah, that motherfucker made that paper off that Chapo.
So in that Chapo, that picture with Sean Penn, and he's wearing that same shirt. Yeah, he's got a big old smile on his face. But anyway, that was pretty interesting. But the interview is really good. It's a 17-minute video that aired on Rolling Stone website, so if you want to look it up. And he said they asked him, you know, why are you doing this? Why are you trying to meet with Sean Penn? He said, listen, it's a reality that drugs destroy. Where I grew up, there's no other way, and there still isn't a way to survive. No way to work in our economy to be able to make a living.
Well, also, them actors, all them motherfuckers fuck with real cocaine. For
ooh,
real.
Ooh.
They in love with the coke. You know, want to go to one of them weird parties we was talking about. Right. Them motherfuckers be passing the tray around. Hey, how are you?
Oh.
Right, all that bullshit.
No, what'd you say that comment was about the kids in UCLA? How they say it to the brothers? How they say it to like, would you, come on, what'd you say they did it when they want them to get high with them?
I don't know. Damn what it. About. Hey, but look, what I'm saying.
You know she got jokes. You about to set her up.
It's coming.
You know
he's gonna get me.
He wants it. No, he wants it. I see what he's doing. Okay.
I got off guard with that. She's like,
It's all right. Keep that hot ass light on, Chris. Keep that light on him.
Yeah, it's like I'm getting hot to the motherfucker.
Good.
Why your glasses on under your nose?
Because I can see. I already told you, Corey. They're for reading, so I can look down if I look straight.
I'm fucking with you. Yeah,
I'm not getting mad. I'm just getting okay.
Are you thinking of evil shit to say?
No, I don't have to think. I'm trying to hold back. Yeah. Okay. You sure you don't do that, Corey? Again, picking stuff up from the floor. You hurt yourself.
Oh, I hurt myself.
Yeah, I heard that one. You did that fat grunt when you're like, ugh.
Yeah. She said the fat grunt.
Just ponytail. What else?
Oh. Because I don't want to let my luxurious hair down. Okay. You didn't dye your gray hair this week? That's why you got your hat on?
Never. You do your shit with a Sharpie. Don't you?
I do sometimes. Only if
we
it's a couple of hairs.
We saw you did it on camera.
I don't deny that. Yeah, I don't care. If it's a couple of them, why am I going to waste a whole box of dye? I'll just do the three little strands.
Okay, well, we just fucking with you, goddammit. What else you do that people want to know?
What else
do I do?
You
like them girls from the ghetto. Them girls from the ghetto, my hood homegirls. These motherfuckers make toilet paper Kotex. They put this shit for about 80 times.
What's it?
With a big thick-ass piece. And they put it right this thing between that Egg McMuffin and walk around all day. That blood can't drip out that motherfucking toilet paper. It's 80 rolls.
Damn,
bitch got a Costco Kotex on under that motherfucker.
All right. Anyway, there was a lot of stars in town. The Golden Globes were this weekend.
Golden Globes.
And it is award season here in Hollywood. So now, you know, once the new year starts, there's like one or two every month for the next few months. But the Golden Globes were this week, past weekend, hosted by Ricky Gervais, who I love. I love that guy. Anyway, it was live. Jamie Foxx, he did a pretty funny joke about Steve Harvey's... What? Anyway, he got up there and he was supposed to give the award for original score for a picture, which is the music in a movie, in case those aren't aware of what it is. Anyway, he made a nice little cute joke about Steve Harvey's flub, you know, about the reading thing. And he got up there, and when he got up there... he hadn't even opened the envelope yet, and he just said, okay, hey, original score for motion picture goes to Straight Outta Compton. And everybody was looking, what the hell? So they started laughing. And then he goes, oh, I'm sorry. He opened it up, and he goes, oh, okay, I'm sorry. I apologize. I take full responsibility. He totally redid the whole Steve Harvey thing. It was pretty funny. And then he said, I apologize to everybody in Compton because you didn't win. So that was pretty cute.
Everybody been going in on Steve Harvey. But, you know, Steve Harvey is a very arrogant man. Okay. So now that everybody got a chance
Why
to get him.
Why would you say that? I've been humble.
Uh-oh.
Can I have another chance?
I knew that nigga was going to get a TV show when he cried on TV. Oh. But that crying is priceless. If you could cry on TV, that almost beat out the dress. You'll get a movie. Oh.
So you could do that then, Corey. You don't have to put the dress on. Let me see. No? Where are the tears?
This nigga look like a blues
singer.
Hold on,
give me a minute. Look
like he's taking a crap.
I'm trying to
cry. Go.
That's not a sad cry. That's like a...
I'm trying to cry. It's hard to cry.
Yeah, no, your cry looks painful.
Get a weep done. God damn it. Show me a girl on a period. God damn it.
Oh, okay. So listen. So let's keep moving. So anyway, the same night, Denzel Washington received the Cecil B. DeMille Award, which is presented every year to an actor to show that, you know, they've made an incredible impact on the world of entertainment. So Denzel received his award, and he took his whole family up there. Now, here we go. This kind of relates to me. I was like, oh, I wish I was there to help him out. Anyway, he was trying to read his speech, and he couldn't. He couldn't see, and finally just turned around. And he asked Pauletta if she had his wife, because the whole family was up on stage with him. His fine son, yeah. His fine older son and the whole kid, yeah. All the twins.
His fine
old son. Fine, his fine older son. I had to throw that in there. He's very handsome.
Oh, his fine old son.
Fine older son.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's very handsome. I am. And he's of age. Anyway, so he couldn't read his speech because he didn't have his reading glasses. So then he turned around and he asked Paulette, and she's like, I don't have mine either. So it was kind of cute. It was a cute moment. So power to the four eyes. That's right, man. See, it's a particular age. Corey, it's going to happen, mother sucker.
Why she want my eyes to go? Because
I don't want them.
Really be campaigning for your eyes,
man. I don't want that to happen. It's just a given. It's a given. The reading part is a given. I'm not saying the distance, but the reading part is going to happen to you, Corey.
The reading part is going to happen to me?
Yes, it's that you're not going to be able to see up close.
I'm not going to be able to see. I'm going to be like you on the 50. Look at today on 5150.
All right. Keep it up.
Yeah. Stack it up. Excellent.
Stack it up.
No, I'm saying, like, my eyes, I can read shit. God damn it.
We need to read now.
We can see the screen up
there. That's distance, Corey.
Says, Steve Harvey is the new TV MC Hammer.
That's distance. Wow. That's distance. I'm talking about close up. It's a given that it happens around a particular age. How old are you again, Corey?
I'm older than a motherfucker.
I asked your age. That doesn't say
old enough for the shit should have happened, but it ain't.
Oh,
happened.
God.
I'm
are you getting in one of those zones,
you
Hollywood?
Because I'm black.
Are you getting a Hollywood zone where you can't see your age?
Looked out for me with my
God. He's going to start going backwards. So now he's going to be 40 or something like that.
God didn't look out on you. Look, better try.
Oh, okay. You already have the old man laugh, so just tell us your age.
You talking about an old man laugh. You got the old lady voice. Just talk. Did everybody listen to D? Go
ahead.
Just
listen.
Corey, could you tell us your age?
Yeah!
God. And he has to shout because you can't hear. I'm assuming your hearing's gone already, too.
I know. Well, you're psycho. You looking at me like this.
No, Corey, that's my
I'm
eyes
right
open.
Here, D.
Are you making fun of tight eyes now, Corey?
Yeah, I'm right here.
Oh, boy, just keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Oh, keep it man. Up.
Keep it
up. All right. Last
you
but not
go
least.
You go to bed now.
Okay, all right.
Get him, D. Do not back up.
Sometimes I just don't even say anything. It's something's just going to happen.
Don't even worry about Corey.
Something's just going to happen, and it don't even have to happen here. Something's going to happen. That's okay.
You let Zoe charge you up.
No, I don't need to. But like
no,
I said, when,
get you. You know
when and
subtle.
You know what? When something happens, that you
when
yeah,
happens,
don't be.
I'm going to remind you.
No, don't be suspecting me. Because I never said anything. If something happens, it's just going to happen. Anyway, if you haven't seen the pictures yet, I gave Chris a few of them.
You know they got them phones with the words.
Here we go.
Jitterbug.
No,
Jitterbug.
They have those not just for sight, but for size, so those fat fingers can hit the right numbers. So I'm going to get Corey one for his B-Day. Anyway. All right, so just a suggestion. Anyway, Obama invited Kendrick Lamar.
Coy.
And this happened way in October, but the pictures have just come surfaced.
Yeah.
Which I love. There's two of my favorites. That's one of my favorites. And then there's one of him and the homies posing in a hallway in the White House. It's hilarious. It's the best looking photo in a long time that I've seen. Anyway, so he invited Kendrick Lamar to a private meeting in the Oval Office, and the visit actually happened in late October, but the photos and the story have just now surfaced. Anyway, Kendrick was already in the Washington area to perform at the Kennedy Center with the National Orchestra.
He's got the main yard poster.
Look at that. It is so dope. Right outside the Oval Office.
That's how you do it.
That's how you do it. Why not? Anyway, they said that Obama had his aides, the White House aides, reach out to them and invite him there. He said that he's a huge fan of Kendrick's and that his favorite song is actually How Much a Dollar Cost.
That's a cut.
My homeboy Joe produced it.
And that's what...
Joe produced
it? The same dude who did your beat to the intro to your show.
What?
Did produced that
track.
My daughter been?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that song, How Much a Dollar.
Well, the president, so Obama said that's his favorite song.
And he produced You Ain't Got a Lie to Kick It.
Mm. Damn.
See?
Joe.
The homie Joe. Right over here.
Joe. I'm tired.
So anyway, so Obama invited him over, came over, and they said that when the president noticed that Kendrick was very nervous, he said that he leaned over to him and he said, he's like, can you believe that we're both in this office?
Wow.
And then he said after the fact,
keep the good shit.
And after Kendrick left, he gave a press conference and then he just said, he's like, hey, you know, bless that kid's heart. He said, you know, He's really a very nice young man. Now, go figure, once the story hit and the pictures hit, people, instead of saying, oh, that's cool, you know what I'm saying? That's pretty cool. Right away, folks are dissing his hairstyle, which were cornrows. They're talking about, oh, the first cornrows and that. Why would he wear his hair like that in the office?
The only thing that motherfucker went in there with Obama's daughter probably was like,
shut up.
He did walk dope, bitch.
And they're also talking about his choice of what he wore, which is
what he supposed to wear?
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. He's him. That's what he wore. But they're making fun of his jeans. They were ripped, and then his cornrows. That's what they're saying. So,
but see, people
enough
like
of that.
That.
But there you
like
go. You see, that's
say
that,
no
that's
matter
the
what
internet.
He do.
Exactly.
He's there to see the president. You're there to
thank
critique
you.
Somebody visiting
no,
the president.
Look, check
right.
this out. So them
fuck
motherfuckers got on their suit and want to see the president.
And they can't. They can't.
Right. So get the
right.
fuck
so goof ass out of here, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
You wearing your shiny.
God damn it. Let me go to the White House. God damn it.
Yeah. Yeah. I can't remember. I don't remember what Easy wore when he went. Remember he met
Easy
with.
Easy had on a motherfucking.
Had on some
Raiders
chucks.
Cap.
Yeah.
Raiders cap, some Lokes and a motherfucking nylon baseball jacket.
Right.
Yup. And a white tee.
That's true.
And
he
some
did.
Motherfucking gloves with his fingers out.
He even cut off
with the net. The neck gloves.
The neck gloves.
That's true.
Jerry Curl juicing in the carpet at the White House.
Oh my God.
He was shaking it, yeah.
Ain't no anyway. Motherfucker about to put on no sucker shit just because you going to the White House. You wear sucker shit when you trying to fuck a bitch and borrow some money from her.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
God damn it. You got to be up to par for that.
So that was
that bitch think you got enough money to pay him back. That's why you got the suit on. You ain't getting this money back.
Loan,
take me to go see Judge Joe Brown. What Judge Joe Brown doing now? I heard that nigga out here bad.
What do you mean? What is he doing?
You know, his wife left him and shit. That TV show
oh,
shit gone. She was like,
well,
fuck you, nigga.
Oh, the light skin dude, Judge Joe Brown with the big head.
Yeah, the Spanish
dude.
Wife, goddamn it, right?
I don't remember. I don't
bitch,
know.
Fuck you, too. I don't need nothing.
You a fool for leaving me.
Nope.
You'll see. You'll see the whole goddamn
did he ever get
world.
His job back after he was arrested?
Judge Joe Brown, little short, bitter motherfucker. Now, I used to be on TV.
Nope.
Oh, he's a short dude?
What? Hey, he wear high heel boots like
no,
Prince.
No,
hey, wait.
Do you remember?
Die for you.
You know what?
Got it if you want me to.
He wear them high heel boots. I saw him at the Beverly Center, and he had on a long like coat. That's what made me look down. Then I looked down, I saw them boots. I was like, this nigga got on some high heel Prince boots. You know Prince real short, so he wear them real tall boots and
right.
shit. Them cat. Cat suit boots.
Hey.
Wow.
You remember he was on the Zoe show?
Who, Judge Joe Brown?
Yeah.
And you let him talk?
You asked him, though.
Zoe
let
that nigga talk for about 20 minutes. Yeah. I want to say, nigga, shut the fuck up.
Then Corey asked him. Corey was like, are you something about him judging people because
right.
now he's in trouble or some shit? Corey.
He had
right.
two cases going.
Corey was
like he used to call niggas fool on TV. Hey, fool. What you need to do and get it together. Hey, fool, you need to stop marrying bitches that don't give a fuck about you.
Oh.
It's going to leave as soon as the TV show over. Goddamn.
Damn.
So he's like, no more fame, no more booty.
So wow. was his feet touching the ground when he was sitting down? Was he swinging his feet and shit?
He probably, real talk, Judge Brown, probably about 5'5", 5'6".
Oh, wow.
A short nigga and shit. Nigga bite your belly button and get into a fight with
you.
Oh, yeah. You motherfucker. Damn, he got it. Damn.
Now I'm going to climb up there and Jimmy that round. I'm going to be a judge. Let all you big motherfuckers know.
Whatever happened to Jenny Jones?
Nobody's taller than
I know.
Bitch.
Whatever. I don't
all
know.
Them people, they just disappear.
Yeah.
Ricky
Lake. One of the
homies from Chicago.
Ricky Lake.
Comedian. He used to be on Jenny Jones. Brother Damon Williams and shit.
Man.
He had on the tutu one time on Jenny Jones.
What?
That's the only thing I love. Nigga had on the tutu.
He put the tutu on
I saw that
Jenny
shit.
Jones
I said,
ooh. Oh, no.
That nigga got on the tutu.
And how much did he get?
I don't know what he got, but I ain't trying to diss
no,
the
yeah.
shit. I'm just saying.
Kinda.
My nigga had on a tutu on Jenny Joe.
What was he doing? Was it
I mean, the Rock put on a tutu?
The Rock put on a tutu, big, but he got
yeah. But I think he got like maybe a million or something like that.
You
I don't know. Maybe
a tutu. Maybe you should have waited for the real tutu money.
Hey man, if I'm lying, I'm dead. My
Jenny
nigga.
Jones check, nigga.
Right. Jenny Jones, you know how they. This is how they all up be in their bedroom. We got him to put it on. He's gonna put it on.
Oh my
gosh!
Oh,
so when
he
when
you
and D-Ray were on the show, did you guys, did they tell you guys what, when you and D-Ray did that one episode?
Of what? Jerry Springer?
Yeah.
Yeah, they had
did they actually go over a story? Did they say, go ahead and just go for it?
Them motherfuckers was trying to geek us up to act like we like that bitch. They got me. They put them roses in my hair right as I walked out on stage.
It was like, boo.
Right when you get to that door, they be like, here, blur. I was like, oh. Yeah, they got me.
Oh, that's too funny.
I mean, we all had our moments. I mean, yeah. I had on no tutu, goddamn it. Right. Fuck that shit, but. Mm-hmm.
So come on, baby, won't you juggle class? Why don't you go to old your ass?
Damn. You don't have to take your...
Uh-huh. All right, fuck it. I was wrong for that.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
God. Hey, dog. Ain't no nigga gonna forget you had a tutu on, man. The fuck is you talking about? Niggas who know what I'm talking about, like...
Nigga did have on a tutu on Jenny Jones.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull it up.
Niggas about to
here,
Google.
Go right here.
Right.
But they're working on it.
Who?
So. You talking about the Rams? We got the Rams.
It happened when? What? It had to have happened within the hour because I just checked it a while
it's
ago.
It's all over.
Why we got the gay team?
No, not over Facebook.
The Rams.
Think about the Rams. Some
but
shit.
But there's another team because it was two. One's gonna go to.
I thought it was Raiders.
Carson and one's gonna go to
Foxhole Rams. That's what we got.
We got the Foxhole Rams.
Anyway, know that the stadium, the one in Inglewood, they claim is gonna be the largest and most beautiful. This is the mayor. Of Inglewood, they said that the HKS design project is going to be the largest and most beautiful stadium in the world.
What does HKS stand for?
Looks like we got the Rams.
No, that's the product. That's the company who's building it.
TMZ is reporting the Rams.
I thought it was. Weren't they going to build a stadium in downtown, like at the college?
No, they dropped that one. That one.
Are they going to keep the name? Or
it's
going to
be
with
Inglewood
name?
Where
they
put it.
They're the Los Angeles Rams.
Los Angeles
the Rams,
Rams
were here. Before.
They were here before. Yeah, they were here before. Yeah.
Before they went to St. Louis.
Back when they were blue and white. Then they went to blue and gold.
Remember that quarterback used to play for them, Chris Everett Lloyd or something like that?
Rosie
got into a fight with dude. He got into a fight with dude on.
You don't remember Rosie Greer?
Yeah, of course. Who
Big
don't remember? Everybody remembers Rosie Greer.
Everybody knows
yeah.
Rosie Greer. Right. Shit, like dog. Ate yeah. a lot of chicken.
Vince Ferragamo and Eric Dickerson.
Dickerson.
You know, they had some players.
That was the curly kid, Eric Dickerson.
Yeah, the Jerry Curl Eric. But hey,
them uniforms used to stay motherfucking bloody and greasy.
You know, bloody and greasy. Where's the blood come from?
The blood comes from they used to hit harder. They could fuck them quarterbacks up back then.
That's true.
Right.
Ain't no saving these little puss-ass quarterbacks back then. Them quarterbacks used to be like.
They got hurt.
What's the old boy called a timeout? What's his name? He's on a Sports Center, and he'd always be like, when he announced stuff, watch the pass go down low as they shuffle the board. He used to be a quarterback for Philadelphia.
And he's on TV now?
Ron Jaworski.
Ron Jaworski.
Yeah. Hey, look. That motherfucker called a timeout in the game because he didn't know where old boy who played for the Giants. What's the linebacker for the Giants? The killer.
Lawrence Taylor.
Lawrence Taylor. Oh, he didn't know where he was, so he called timeout. He said, where's Lawrence Taylor? He was on the bench.
That's
it's
too
like,
funny.
Fuck that. Where that crazy motherfucker That's ultimate respect right
That's
there.
Respect.
When the motherfucker looking for you every play, where that nigga at? Block that nigga right there. Nigga didn't even say, he didn't even say hut. He said block.
Go get him.
Fuck that shit.
Sick with it.
LT, Lon Taylor, goddamn it.
Yeah,
knock them quarterbacks down and go buy that pussy, nigga.
And them little soap-colored rocks.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, so it is. My influence is working.
Oh, my favorite, Lemonhead Delight, when you lick off all the yellow and sell the white.
Oh!
Yeah, you remember that Goodie Mob?
Yeah,
I know Lawrence
Taylor
was listening to that shit.
Goodie Mob, well, I remember the first time I heard their album, Soul Food, I was like, who the fuck is these motherfuckers, these little Atlanta niggas?
They killed it. They did.
I met that nigga CeeLo, CeeLo.
We are tonight, today. I think I'm crazy.
That was a hot A. That was a dope ass record, though.
Everything. I love shit.
No, I knew
and
he was
rapping like a motherfucker, too.
Yeah, see.
Who you really think that you are?
I'm talking about lyrically, he dope.
Oh, yeah.
Always.
If most I of those very eclectic easy guys way, are
I
like
wouldn't
that.
Be the strong nigga that I am today.
Right.
Sometimes I kind of like being Poe. At least I know what my friends here for.
Hey, CeeLo, if yeah, you're listening, CeeLo. I heard your song Getting Grown. That motherfucker was cold.
That's cold.
Oh, yeah. He's
right
good.
And then
yeah.
he got the other one, Follow
this
Me.
This is Carlito yeah. from a couple
album.
Of days ago. Remember?
Right. Beautiful black.
Was that his first? Hello, was that his first solo Carlito album from a couple of days ago? Excuse me. Fuck,
whatever.
Yeah. We be talking to the motherfuckers.
Yeah, yeah, I love that dude, man. That's yeah. one of the most talented artists we got. He, to me, real. We don't have enough of his music.
Right.
You really gotta know that CeeLo shit to know what that is. Still standing.
Yeah, still standing.
God damn it. CeeLo. CeeLo. Yeah, was the Super Chicken? Was that his first album?
Super
that
Chicken.
Was a song, Super Chicken. It was on there.
Probably sound like it.
I'm gonna go find that.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, that's the best album he ever made, and he done made some dope albums. But that break. One, man. Mm-hmm. Oh, we gotta take a break. Chris doing this to his hand.
You Chris. Should just hold up a glass and go, and when it shatters, we'll know. Oh. Time to take a break.
Right. You know what?
The glass broke.
Chris almost got frostbite. Chris let his hand sit outside till the frostbite kick in. He be like, oh. He be back to normal.
He was in Philly warming
mm-hmm.
up the project.
Tell him, Chris.
I'm home. Right.
You know,
hands behind for 3 weeks.
Stop.
The windows. Chris is right. back.
Stop.
Thanks, Chris. He's like,
the snow's melting.
Who got some jumper cables? Right. Hey, Chris, come here. I need some jumper cables.
Oh,
the blizzard's over. Summer mouth is here.
Call him July.
Whoa, whoa. Okay, so going in on the okay.
Zone it in.
All right. Oh.
Summer mouth. I like that one. That's going to stick.
Summer mouth.
Like right.
Muggy breath. Muggy breath is muggy.
Oh. Weltering watermelon mouth. No, fuck that way. Hey,
yeah.
So we're going to take a break. God damn it. 5150 Nation. We shall return you. Fuck!
Cause your paper up, you with the boss players who fingers got the paper cuts. Smooth old money niggas showing you the ropes, but can't forget about the ones that know you the most. When niggas stop showing love, they gon' show you the toast. Butter that shit right in front of you, then feed you the loaf. Jelly shit, niggas hungry and they belly shit. Then you catch your man on some bullshit. Like, really, kid? This how it's gon' go down? Us in the chrome 4 pound? What, you gon' pop me, then peel yourself, you gon' blow your crown? What, I'm a bozo now? You think a nigga changed? Cause I'm on some buy any mean shit to get the change. My nigga, you buggin'. It's like you want something, like you don't care about the future, you don't want nothing. Your man ain't trying to hear it, envy controls his mind. He holding 4+5, he trying to blow your mind. Cause see, he felt betrayed, he felt like he got played. His Timbs is leaning right now, your Ferragamo suede.
Yeah, MC Hood and a hat. I'm trying to freestyle off this beat. Check it out. At the schoolyard, talking to this fly bitch. She a senior in high school, so she ready for the dick. Going to her prom, I got a car. Put my thing in your mouth, bitch, you'll go far. I spend this paper on all you fatherless hoes. Like the rest of these little niggas in your school, suck my toe. I wanna get that ass the day I meet you. If not, Ike Turner, bitch, I'm gonna beat you. Coming with this fucked up flow. Niggas marry fucked up hoes.
Yep.
That's all right, put on the show.
Show.
And freeze, go.
Bald head bitches, why you in the beauty shop? Look at your bald head. Bitch, you know you need to stop. Go put a hat on. Tie a rag around your skull. Cause every time I see you, I be like, oh no. Here you go. Slick head, bald head hoe. Looking like, shiny like a window. Shiny like the front of an aluminum foil. Bitch, your hair fucked up and your breasts are spoiled.
Bald head bitches in the shop. Damn, I hate it. Bald head hoes talking about,
can my shit be braided?
Bald head hoes, get the fuck out. Look at your skull, bitch. It brings doubt when you get yours. Every man look like you supposed to be with him. Take that wig off, bitch. Your body gonna be like, go get him.
This is all to the bald-headed hoes out there. This is dedication to all you hoes.
Dedicated to all you bitches who call with the makeup. Fool the shit out of nigga type bitches.
And another thing, I like to give a shout out to all the bald head hairdressers. You bad. You are bad. If you bald headed, make a bitch sit in your chair to get her hair done, that's a bad bitch.
That's a bad bitch.
That's manipulation, motherfuckers. Big shout out to all the bitches who always keep their toenails polished, cause that toe black than a motherfucker. You about to have a heart attack, bitch.
Bald headed hoes.
We gotta make a song about black toe bitches.
Black toe hoes.
Bitch always got up. When you see a bitch and her motherfucking toenails always polished, you be like, hold on. Let me see your toe. Take that motherfucking polish off. Look like it's pennies under your motherfucking nails.
And that's a deal changer, huh? So something you can't see. That's a deal changer. Well, why do you want to take the toenail polish off?
So you can see, goddammit.
But if you don't see it,
you gotta see what
out of sight, out of mind.
Sometimes you want to see what the fucking motherfucking foot look like for real. Take
yeah,
your
right?
toenail polish off, D.
I do have it off right now because it's wintertime.
Hold on, you got on that gym sock. Don't do that.
Yeah, a lot of times I don't have them painted. I just have like a clear.
Oh, let's see.
Oh, shit.
Got some pretty little feet there, girl.
Well, I ain't got them little turtle head feet.
Yeah, right. Very funny. At least I can count mine. Yours are all together. One solid. Can you wiggle your toes?
Did let's you see that look he just gave me?
Take his shoe off, Corey. Let's see if you can wiggle them. Can you wiggle them?
What shoes I got on?
Yeah, what do you have on? Let me see.
I don't want everybody to see my shoes.
Why not? Uh-huh. Here we go. Here we go.
He loves showing his shoes, by the way.
You see those?
Warn me when you take it off so I don't inhale. Ready? One, two.
These them
shoes. I'm going to hold it. Ready?
These them shoes that Coy dude had on in that movie, The Foxhole Wiz.
Oh, what are the size?
Microwave kickers.
Stop.
Hip hop astronauts.
What?
My Nipsey Russell in the Wiz shoes.
Tap dance shoes.
Slide the boy. I wear weird shit.
MC Time Traveler.
Koi corns. Taquito feet. Hey, who is FOAB? They say Corey toes suck together like biscuits. That's a moist.
Oh, see?
Flirting on the motherfucker.
Oh, well, you told him in that rap, in that freestyle, somebody to suck your toes.
I didn't say something.
Yes, you did. You said something about a guy suck your tongue. Huh? What did he say?
No dude.
Yes, you did, Corey. We turned around and we were like, you don't want to do that. You did.
Wait, I said a dude suck
my
toes?
Yeah, you said something about the boys. Something about boys. Suck my toes.
No.
Yes. Oh, like, you guys aren't observant.
The girl
we're
do
observant.
It to all the other guys.
No. Chris, we might have to replay it. We have to replay it back because we immediately turned around. We're like, oh my God, huh?
Get your boiled lagoon boy's ass out of here. They go swimming in the lagoon, the fish
you
be
said
cooked.
Something to the effect of boys suck my toes.
I ain't saying no boys.
All right, here we go. All right.
He said he got one of Montel Jordan.
Oh.
I was like, what?
He said Corey got one of Montel Jordan.
Montel Jordan. Fuck you, nigga.
Not the Michael Jordan. Montel Jordan.
The lowercase G.
It's all right.
Stupid.
Anyway, how are you doing? That Montel Jordan. I would like to recognize voices of power that are on the air.
Yep.
That are on the TV.
Mm-hmm.
I want to say to my man Tom Joyner, I don't know what's going on with your radio show and shit, but I want to thank you for all the opportunities you gave me. Come on your show. You've been doing this a long time. I know you're a triple OG. Much respect to you, Tom Joyner.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Much respect.
That's real.
Help a lot of people out, man.
A lot of guys to school.
A lot of
people.
A lot of kids to school.
Yeah, man.
A lot of philanthropic work.
Yeah.
Through the vehicle of the radio.
Yeah, man.
That's right.
Gotta give him love for that. Pioneer.
And has always been a very personable, nice guy. Approachable.
Yeah.
It's nice.
That's why, you know what I'm saying? It's like I want to dedicate this show to giving props to people who doing shit. Brother Dr. Umar Johnson, I haven't met you yet, but I watch what you do, man. I'm an admirer.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Good brother.
You know what I'm saying?
Good brother. When he was here in L.A., I had to go down there just to show up. Just to let him know that the voices from the 5150 show, from the Zo What show, because he's done the Zo What show before. I had to let him know I'm in the building.
Yes.
And I got a chance to holler at him real quick, and it was cool. So, as a matter of fact, we're working on trying to get him through here.
Yeah.
So, the brother's work is needed and necessary for the community, for sure.
Mm-hmm. You know, man, people who have the, who dare go out on a limb and not do what, they feel they boss want them to do, want them to say. I mean, you know, it's always a good thing when I meet these people, man. I was watching the internet the other day. What's the brother name we was trying to get on the show?
Dr. Boyce Watkins.
Yeah, man.
Another heavy hitter.
Yeah, man.
Doing major positive work in the community in terms of wealth business, building, has business seminars. I think he's doing something with Tariq. Tariq Nasheed, that's another voice.
He did a show with Dame Dash, like a class called Intelligent Boss Moves.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, Dr. Boyce is doing some heavy things, and he'll be here shortly, too.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. You mean he's coming to Los Angeles, or he's coming on the show? Because he's definitely coming on this show, if I could hook it up.
Yeah.
It's just I'm trying to set up this studio. Set up this little ass spot where I'm this close to Darlene.
Oh, all right.
Who else you like out there speaking?
I'm just fucking with you, D. Stop getting mad and shit for it.
Ain't nobody getting mad. Believe me. You'll know.
D.L. Hughley?
Yeah, D.L. Hughley, man. You know what I'm saying? I was looking on his Twitter page, and he puts a lot of the business out there on what's going on as far as it go with all of these corrupt-ass police officers murdering unarmed people, and he also displays how they get away with it.
Mm-hmm.
And on his radio show, he speak on it.
Jesse Williams, the actor.
Who?
Jesse Williams. He'll go head up with folks, too.
Yeah.
He's from Grey's Anatomy. He's always in arguments with people and going head up on shows, on debates. And Wendell Pierce.
I know you're talking
he
about.
Is no joke. Yeah, Wendell Pierce.
Yeah.
The dude from The Wire and from Waiting to Exhale. He's joke, too.
So, Corey, you going to give Stephen A. Smith some props for... He's been chopping down some people. People have been attributing it to us calling him out. I don't think it's that, but...
Well, I know he feel that pressure from here.
Yeah.
Hmm. You know what I'm saying? I mean, no matter what,
he's
still a black man.
Yeah.
You're a black man. I know you feel it. When you get up there and you say things that you know make your boss happy, okay, you do that and you justify it by saying you got to make these ends, okay.
Well,
but then he'll say something that basically contradicts the way that he must think. You know what I mean? Like, well, if you're bold enough to say that, to think like that, how could you think like this on other ends? But that's why I started out the show talking about, oh, he don't get it. Right. You know what I mean? He feel like Bear Bryant gave people opportunities. Bear Bryant, he went and got niggas because he needed niggas.
Needed them to stay relevant, just to compete.
Right. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Motherfucker Bear Bryant. And all the rest of them motherfuckers from back in the day who was on that bullshit with me and mine.
What about Eddie Griffin, who came out hard in defense of Bill Cosby?
Yeah, and big ups to Eddie Griffin. Gave me a hell of a shout out in the interview too. That's the homie.
Yeah,
that is the homie. Eddie, I'm gonna tell you something about Eddie Griffin.
Just like his ass when he was talking that shit when he talking about T.D. Jakes' old folks concert.
That's real. Yeah, Eddie Griffin, that nigga is old. I've never seen Eddie Griffin back down or double step on his on his shit.
Kansas City. And I'll tell all them motherfucking crackers, you better back the fuck up. Eddie Griffin's in this motherfucking. I run out of funny for you run out of money, nigga.
That's the homie for real. Always will be. Much
but I think that's the point of having a platform. If we not informing or trying to enlighten, or at least have the fucking discussion where people can go back and then join us through Twitter and other, you're wasting your platform. We gotta use this platform to educate.
Right.
Because the rest of the shit on TV dumbed in a motherfucker. Right? And if we're not, you know, the counterculture to that, you know, we just adding to the problem.
That's real.
That's I'm right, Sinbad be talking that shit too though.
Sinbad?
Yeah.
I met Sinbad. That's a cool brother, man. Yeah. That guy you see? That's Sinbad for real.
For real. I met him too up at the Foxhole. And when the motherfucking mics was off, first off, when the mics was on, he was still on. He was still giving it up. And then when the mics was off, he got even realer with the shit.
Right.
So,
Sinbad's real. Sinbad made a movie I worked on. There's a boom operator back in the day called Cherokee Kid about black cowboys. And that was a fly movie to work on because it was, man, he had, I never
was
knew.
Was it his production?
It was his production. He wrote it. He was in it. Gregory Hines was in it.
Wow.
James Colburn, OG James Colburn was in it. It was a lot. And the main thing is he had all the black cowboys, the National Black Cowboy, all the dudes.
Yeah,
I used to go to that every year.
Yeah, he gave them all jobs. And they was in the movie and highlighted their skills and brought light to the black cowboys. There's a lot of black, man, I go as far as to say is
just as many.
There was a lot of black cowboys, a lot.
They have a rodeo every year.
They had Nike boots on.
Very funny.
Spurs, all that.
Hey, no, we got to give Killer Mike. Killer Mike is out there spitting that reel.
Yeah.
It's a few.
Let me say this, though. It ain't always about. See, this is another thing that I always like to clear up. I always say I don't feel like all Caucasian people are prejudiced. Some of them fall in line with the way the bullshit's set up. But I know as I was trying to shoot my DVD, I reached out to all the niggas I know. And I could not.
Get the niggas
to do it.
And then the white boy stepped through and was real.
The niggas was talking real crazy about even trying to mislead and misguide me with, oh, well, if you spend that much, you got to get it shot like this, that, and the other, and then it won't be ready for TV. I won't say their names today,
But knowing you.
But no, I'm just saying. It's like, I can't believe this nigga is on the phone trying to run game about if you don't pay this much, you can't get this type of camera and all.
What do white men tell you?
Man, look, I did a show in Sacramento, and I met these white boys. See, let me tell you something. It's just some, just like you say, it's real niggas. It's some real hunkies out here.
For real.
Motherfucker ain't about that bullshit. Well, and that motherfucker told me, look, I can do it for this. And you know, I knew that was the right price. You know what I'm saying? Meaning like for what you getting done. You know what I'm saying? And he was saying, he said, I don't give a fuck if I lose or I win. I'm not going to quote you nothing different later on down the line.
Ooh, there it is. See that?
You get this job with these Hollywood ass niggas who motherfucking to tell you this, and then they sucker you for this later on.
Yeah.
And I'm just saying, it's like these the black camera guys I know in LA. Mm. I ain't mad at you. You know what I'm saying? Do your thing. But I'm just saying, going out your way to lie about what some shit costs and then tell you that, oh, well, if you do it like this, you can't get this. Nigga, shut the fuck up, nigga.
You ain't got the thingamajig?
Right.
Oh, well, if you ain't got the thingamajig, you might as well just not even do it, because you got to have the thingamajig.
Them niggas. We got to give love to David Banner.
David Banner.
Oh, hell yeah. David
Banner speak
that real. We got to give love to Dr. Joy DeGruy.
That's family right there.
Thank you, Freeze Love, for hooking that up.
Mm-hmm. And thank you, Dr. Joy.
She came on the show and destroyed.
Always, man.
Got to give love to that sister. If you don't know who she is, look her up.
I know I'm going to look her up.
It's not a game.
I don't know her.
You do. You had her thing. You talked about her.
She's amazing.
No,
you talked about her video.
Oh, where she, you realize where, that's the same person.
When she asked that audience of Caucasian, system of racism.
Now I know you're
raise
talking
your
about.
Hand.
Yeah. She's amazing.
She's incredible. She came on the show on the Voice of Reason show on Dash Radio, and destroyed.
I believe.
And left it in shambles.
Mm. I believe it. There are some people out here who so on top of their shit that you love to put them in a room full of these so-called elitist motherfuckers, so
they can make a fool out of them. For a person like her, they're gonna be I ain't even gonna talk to
all that elitist shit. That's just arrogance. It's not intelligence. Yeah. It's not something that you learn. You don't learn to be an elitist. You just go to a school and you call yourself that. But at Harvard, at Yale, all these schools, it's just drunk motherfuckers who getting by off their name and off their color and off their family's money.
Yeah.
I'm going to name a white woman who is out here talking that real. She's been doing this shit for 45 years, breaking down the conditioning of white privilege to white people. And a lot of white people see her as abusive because she's harsh. Her name is Jane Elliott.
Yeah.
She be on white people's head. She said, if you live 30 minutes of a black person's life, you'd understand what I'm trying to explain to you about white privilege. Jane Elliott. If you don't know who she is, look that motherfucker up.
She's in a room full of white women. She says, now, right now, I want you to all look around, look at each other. Now, which one of you here would trade places with a black person? Aha, you see? You see, so the fact that none of you are standing up, none of you are raising your hand, that lets me know that you know.
You know.
You know.
That you don't want to live that life.
You know.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's people out here who bold enough to go against the grain. And I just got so much respect for motherfuckers. Who is Dr. Phil Valentine? Because they
Dr. Phil Valentine. He be on the Zowa show all the time.
Well, even David Bowie, rest in peace. He's always spoke his mind.
He had a black wife, though.
But, and people like, didn't matter.
David
even before
said
that.
Something good.
No, but even before that. Years before
that.
You know what?
He had a deep voice for a girl.
No. She just had the accent. She had the African accent.
Well, I don't give a fuck. It's a deep voice. Get that James Earl Jones sound, bitch.
Deep motherfuckers with the phone.
No, that was Naomi.
Oh, that was Naomi.
Let me just say this.
I knew it was one of the tall guys.
We lost one of the realest voices ever in Frances Cress Welsing. That sister was on white people's head back in the 80s. on Donahue, smashing Donahue up.
That's what's up.
So, I mean, it's a lot of voices out there, man. There's some young cats out there.
We gotta give them their props because I wanna eventually network with these people.
Yeah.
And start what I would like to call our own network because, you know, they'll give these guys their shine. Meaning like Hollywood will pick whoever they gonna pick who fits into the category. Cause let me tell you something. I travel all over the country and I always cut on the news to see what black man they got on the news. Mm. And it's all homosexual black men on the news. Given the news. When you black. Mm. I'm saying like,
but see, you know
this
is
not no coincidence. I'm like, why is there so many gay black men delivering the news?
But well, not just gay. Not just gay, but I hear what you're saying. I'm actually kind of perplexed when I turn on, I've always said this even about, what's homeboy's name? Jim that does the sports. I said, why can't they change their, here in the local news? They've got a certain look to them. And I remember I asked somebody this, and they said, oh, well, it's not, it's easy.
That's the key.
For people to, you know what I'm saying, to look at them and talk. They don't want to see the cornrows, or they don't want to see the fade. Because I was like, why doesn't he change his hair? He's had that same hairstyle. They Wait, all look the same.
Jim,
no.
She's talking about brother.
Yeah, man.
Jim Wilson.
No.
Jim Rose.
Channel 7. Channel 4. Yeah, Channel 7. The same look, and I was like, what is wrong with his look? They can't. He's like, they got him back.
Right there. We in L.A. Jim Brown? No. We in Gosh, L.A., man. What's his name? We've been knowing him for years.
I know this girl. He used to be with him at the Barbary Coast and the First King on the regular.
Stop.
His teeth ain't buck, but they big.
They're big.
What's his name? Anybody from L.A. know who we talking about?
And he's got that.
Jim Hill.
And he's got that perfect. That guy. Never changes. He's got the same
got that perfect
little
teddy bear round helmet afro.
Steve Harvey fro before Steve found out.
Right.
Steve saw him and said, I want a haircut just like that dude.
He just squared the
That's a winner's haircut.
A winner's
haircut. I'm going to keep it until I go all the way to the top.
Yeah. Non-threatening. That's it. That's what I was going to say. Non-threatening look.
But you have to understand.
Genteel.
You have to understand. The most feared man. Let's just hear that. The most feared man on planet Earth is the black man. So if the black man is going to rise high in a system that has already been proven to be systemically racist, right? There's no way possible you can have the most feared man in his natural state rising up that system. Because if he's in his natural state, that means he's gonna take that shit. Even in our docile state, you bring us into sports, we take over sports. You bring us into any environment, we tend to take over. So what they have
Why do you think we take over?
Because we the
it's just,
shit.
It's just natural. Yeah. It's just natural. I had a
you know what it is?
Dark is dominant, light is recessive.
No,
Well, it's more than that, though.
Yeah. If you pour some chocolate milk and some white milk,
hold on,
that milk gonna be beige. It's gonna be freeze love colored milk.
Let me tell you, I had a sister on the show. This very powerful.
Can't milk white milk out of dark milk.
Whether you believe in this shit or not, it's a white woman. She's a psychic. She's on this list that this private detective and FBI guy put together of certified psychics, right? Guys, people that when the police say, okay, we need to find this missing girl, they go to them.
Every time I rape one of them bitches, I'd be like, bitch, you
should've
knew.
God damn it, I know you just,
You should've knew, bitch.
This guy. No, but you know what she said?
Fuck yeah!
You know what she said? She said, the only alpha males, this is from a white woman. She said, the only alpha males on planet Earth are black.
What did that mean?
She said, there are no alpha males in any other ethnic group.
Hold on, man. Archie Bunker was an alpha male.
No, he wasn't. God damn it. Archie Bunker was crying and tripping.
He's a whiner.
You call this a beer?
Come here, meathead.
You fucking meathead.
Anyway, no, I get what you're saying. It's real, like, and that point was brought up because, you know, I know a lot of guys who have to play down who they are because they are big, dominant brothers. You know what I'm saying? It's like when you walk in a room and you're getting ready to ask for a light and you're a big black man, you got to be like, hey, can I get a light? Like you got to calm them
right?
down first.
Right.
It's all good. I ain't about to knock the shit out. Let me get a light, homie. Mm-hmm. They give you the light like this. Mm-hmm. Oh. I feel it.
Remember Brian Bosworth was supposed to be Billy Badass, right? Coming out of OU, Oklahoma. He was supposed to be this bad motherfucker. Until he ran into Bo Jackson. And it changed his fucking life when he got ran the fuck over. Listen, the black man, this is why they try to relegate us to sports. They try to relegate us to shit that they can control, right? You just get out there and run the ball. We'll handle the numbers, okay? We'll handle the contracts. We'll handle all of that. You just play the game.
Yeah.
But when you start getting black men outside of the construct of the game as a player and then put them in the position to be an owner or put them in position to be a general manager, you start to see black men operate slightly different.
Mm-hmm.
White people are afraid of us coming up those ladders with an awareness of self.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, they're afraid of that.
So that's why so many moist newscasters, yeah, that's what they want to put out there.
You motherfucking
That's what they want you to see. So I want to say to all of you sportscasters, you newscasters, especially the CNN group. Oh, my God. Mm. This is embarrassing. This is embarrassing. When I see them dudes on CNN that's black, I be like, oh, my God, what is this? Mm. You are there to represent weakness.
Oh, no, listen.
You are there to represent
some heavy shit, man.
The worst of us.
Yeah.
That's why you're there. So when you sit there with your lip gloss and pseudo, I'm sitting on my couch getting ready to change the channel. But right before I change it, I always say, this bitch ass nigga.
Hey, and you know what's crazy?
What the fuck they got him on TV for?
Non-threatening.
Crazy about what you're saying?
Yeah.
Nigga.
They're meeting the quota.
Listen, just go ahead and say the man's name. You know who you talking about.
You know who I'm talking about. He's one of them, but he just one of them. Homie, I was in Memphis, Tennessee this weekend. Real nigga central. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. They ain't all the way country. They ain't all the way city. They right there in between. Memphis, right. Tennessee.
Mm.
Man, I cut on the news. I ain't even seen no moist motherfuckers in Memphis. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Until I cut on the news.
Right.
Today, a little boy got hit by a car and he was hurt so bad. Oh.
See, but Corey, you saying this.
Who is this pussy motherfucker, man, telling the news?
You know.
They were shooting over there.
They need brothers. I believe they need brothers in those positions because they need brothers to act like women. Let me give you an example. A woman is scared as fuck to lose her job. You know how much abuse women take from bosses? Because they know they don't want their fucking life disrupted. So a woman tends to take shit from the boss. If you get an alpha in a company,
they ain't gonna go very far.
He's not gonna,
yeah,
he's
not
gonna
climb
let
the ladder.
You talk reckless to him.
Right.
And they know that.
Right.
If you're a black man
that operates like a woman.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a black man, I don't give a fuck what kind of degree you have accomplished. If you are a black man who is proud to be a black man, I just can't even imagine a job you can excel in. You know what I mean when I say that?
Yeah.
Like, where could you
other
work?
Than, right, other than entertainment or sports.
Yeah, and the entertainment and all that, and it's not about your talent level. It's about your relationship levels.
It's real.
You know what I'm saying? So you can be the most talented entertainer in the world. That don't mean you're going to make it.
No,
your
right.
relationship.
You got to have the disposition to match your
talent.
That
you go to school to get this degree that certifies you to be able to work in certain environments. You don't fit in unless you put your tail between your legs. I'm just saying, it doesn't. There's no job in the world that you could get where you can be a proud black man. You will be fired.
And let's define proud black man, because there are many out there who are listening to the show who may think we're saying,
you're judging on his looks. Right. What if he is proud?
You get to gangbang on TV, or you get to, you know, be inappropriate or disrespectful. That's not what Corey is saying. Corey is saying you get to be a proud black authentic man, not a young dumb thug who kills other brothers. We're not talking about that. We're talking about a real man in him, in the power in element, of himself, right, in his element. Mm-hmm. If you can't be that, if you can't be that, who are you? But you know,
a puppet.
Exactly.
Well, that's what I'm saying. That's why I was upset when they were getting on Kendrick for his outfit. That's him. That's him. See what I'm saying?
That's real.
Mm-hmm. Chris wrote down, that's proud real. Black men can only excel in jobs they create for themselves. Let me tell you something, man. That's just real. By me doing this 5150 show, I risk it all. I risk it all. But I'm not afraid to be outcast by them people. Them people meaning all the motherfuckers. That ain't just white people. That's all the motherfuckers who want to fit into that motherfucking bullshit-ass system that they creating, where motherfuckers don't want to walk outside the line because they scared somebody going to be like, oh, you can't work here no more.
Right.
Or, oh, you can't do this no more because you said this, you said that.
You don't want to rock the boat, right.
I'm not afraid to be in that category, because I just feel like that category will send me to my death quicker. Right. If I can't speak my mind, I'll die.
Right.
I'm going to tell you something, too. That category is getting older and older and more played out and less powerful. Because people don't, you think people want to hear that bullshit, but a lot of people don't.
Don't want to hear what?
That fake shit, that game, that same old, same old. Mm-hmm. People want the real. These kids, a lot of these kids want the real. They're not selling for the bullshit.
What you laughing at?
I don't know.
Somebody said Corey weighs 3,000 pounds.
What?
That's funny.
Yes.
Big dog, 127.
Big dog, 127.
Okay, you feel that way, motherfucker. Fuck you too, Zoe. But I'm just saying. I'm just saying. It's like, you're not alone when you're at work in your cubicle and you're thinking what you're thinking. Because there's a lot of young guys who have went to college and did what they said was necessary to fit in. And they're somewhere sitting in a cubicle every day.
Depressed,
like,
exactly,
oh
yeah.
Oh, my God.
Letting life pass them by.
I can't even talk like I would talk, or I'll be fired.
This is why The Weeknd means so much to motherfuckers.
Yeah, you see all the commercials and the movies and the jokes about it.
That,
yeah.
That little 48 hours, nigga, is everything.
Where you're not yourself.
To the average motherfucker. Because you spend the majority of the week somebody else. That's the worst feeling in the world.
And that's why you got places in Europe where they get it. And they're like, okay, we're going to have to give longer lunches and an extra day on the weekend. Like, they know it. They're like, okay, the outcome that we get from these people being happier, living their lives a little truer and a little longer, makes a better, you know, better outcome for the work that's done.
Exactly.
In Italy, there's a lot of places where they get it right.
A lot of these jobs.
Shut down, like everything closes.
Yo, they get 2 months vacation. 8 weeks throughout the year.
See, that's so it's a lovely. Lot of different here.
You get
2 weeks?
It's almost like imagine working 30 years putting on a smile? It's like that movie, The Butler, I saw. I saw that shit, The Butler. I was like, the deep shit about this movie is they justified this motherfucker fitting in. You see what I mean when I say that?
But it gets praised, like, this.
Don't you say nothing about that butler. He put you through school. Yeah, he put you through school, but his son is in the middle of a fucking war.
At the cost of his integrity.
You see what I'm saying?
That's why he put you through school.
Yeah.
And then that's seen as some type of heroic shit.
Because he shut the fuck up and didn't say what needed to be said when it needed to be said.
I'm gonna say this. Did you what's old girl from what's the TV show, the hit TV show with the sister and the brother?
Striker.
Scandal.
No. No. Who? No.
The other one on Fox.
Empire.
That shit. What's the lead sister name?
Taraji P. Henson.
She kind of went in on her Golden Globe acceptance speech.
Yeah, I caught something
like
that.
She kind of went in. You know, she was like, oh, I got a Golden Globe. And, you know, she was very appreciative and thankful for it. Mm-hmm. But she was like, oh, I thought I would have got it for the role I played on Will Smith's movie. Or she was naming other roles that had real meaning mm-hmm. to it. Mm-hmm. She was like, oh, I thought I would have been acknowledged for that one mm-hmm. or for this one over here. But a crackhead or somebody who went to jail for 17 years... She kind of went in. I was like, okay, I fuck
they
with Taraji on this one.
They slept on that. They didn't get
one.
That. They didn't want to,
she threw that out. Like, if you look at Cookies, you know, she's a convict, you know, all this and that. She kind of went in. I said, okay, I can fuck with that.
Yeah.
But you got to do that underhand shit with them white folk. Because they even had the room segregated. You got the movie stars up front and the TV motherfuckers in the back. That's classism.
That's how they've done it.
It was black and white all over the room.
Yeah, I know.
But the movie stars is up here, and the TV motherfuckers is in the back. I said, okay, I see the Hollywood class going down right now.
Yeah.
Man, I would
shit
just
was gangster.
Love to be at one of them award shows.
I went once, a long time ago.
And get an award.
Oh,
just so I could change the way. You know how they got in schools with the metal detectors now? Because motherfuckers did some shit where they was like, enough is enough. If they give me an award, I'm telling you now, I'm going to change the way they motherfucking allow niggas to come. The award show going to be pre-recorded.
Like the seat filler that ran up when Cheryl Underwood and the whole crew from the show got their award. Did you see that?
Whatever.
A seat filler dude. He ran up in the middle of the thing and did like a Kanye and like grabbed the mic and started talking on his crazy stuff.
Really?
Yeah, recently. You gotta look it up. It's pretty funny.
Wow. I see Phil. Well, they got motherfuckers to fill the seats, so when they clapping, it ain't no gaps in the seats.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That makes sense. Sit your ass in the seat.
Seat, and he...
You here to fill a seat, man.
He got up and said, he purposely went so he could do that.
I remember Garth Brooks got an award, the country dude, and he went up there and he said, for all the people who didn't get what they deserve, I'm gonna just leave this right here. Thanks a lot.
Wow.
Just watch the fuck off.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go make some beach nut and chew it.
Some beach nuts.
Spit all over this son bitch and place.
What's one of his songs? Anybody know it here?
Guys, I don't know.
I just wanted people to see that shit. Garth Brooks, all of awards.
That motherfucker
who in here
was
knows
gigantic.
His song?
I don't know none of his records. Not one.
What was one of his albums name?
My shoe.
Right.
Some shit like
I'm going to lead the trophy right here. I'm gonna leave this trophy right
here. Take a gander.
Take a gander is his hit record.
Yeah. Country people are like the closest thing to like the white folks, you know, brothers. You know what I'm saying? Like they do. They look at him like that.
Oh, yeah.
Johnny Cash. Oh,
country
he was all
folks
black,
sing with a little soul.
Show up all, yeah.
Stories, man.
I've been chopping this wood every day of my life.
We say grace, and we say ma'am, and if you ain't from the South, then we don't give a damn.
Well, I can run a buck, and I can run a trout line, and the country boy will survive.
Mm-hmm. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere.
No, Johnny Cash is the baddest.
Is that who's
the Ring of Fire?
His song, I like the Johnny Cash song.
I love
was
the
one
Ring
where
of Fire.
Said, I shot a man just to watch him die.
Yeah.
I got a man just
Johnny
Cash.
Johnny Cash did concerts in the pen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Straight up in the pen with no guards. Oh, like, God, let all these men, here's your men today. And
you know, ain't no ass getting way up here, boy.
Stop.
Johnny Cash.
I've been everywhere, man.
But I ain't going there, Sam.
Sometimes them country singers be having the coldest slow songs.
Hank Williams Jr.
She broke my heart in rain on the day I bought my new boat. Broke my heart. That's why the bitch got choked.
Yeah, they probably yeah. would. Yeah.
You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. Before hungry children and the crop in the field. I've seen some bad times, lived through some sad times. This time you left me for real.
The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas is one of my favorite movies. Yo, I love the soundtrack.
Hey, I heard all that shit.
Urban Cowboy.
The army with the dude from Texas named Hale. He used to play that country music every morning. I used to play it.
Devil Down in Georgia. That's my favorite one.
With the fiddle battle. Whoa. That dude was rapping.
Devil Down in Georgia is one of the baddest country songs ever.
Devil Down in Georgia.
In the movie Urban Cowboy, when he performs it live.
Like a rhinestone cowboy.
Yo, go check out the Wild Wonderful Whites of West Virginia.
Oh, Jesus, it's too many W's. Say it again.
The Wild Wonderful Whites of West Virginia. You go see that, you see the tapping outlaws. Mm. Yo, Johnny Nashville produced this show a few years ago. But that'll show you some.
Listen, back in the day, let me just say, back in the day, before there was motherfucking In Living Color, motherfuckers used to watch Hee Haw.
Hee Haw, yeah, that's right.
Don't play yourself.
No, you're
but
right.
See, I could never give them shows their true credit because it was only like four other things to watch on TV while Hee Haw was on.
That's true, but
you watched Hee Haw.
And you would have never been one shit else on.
found another. She met another. And she was
gone. What was the name of that song?
Beverly Hillbillies. Beverly Hillbillies was cool, too.
It wasn't nothing.
Niggas watched The Dukes of Hazzard, too.
Oh, that's true.
After you watched Benny Hill.
Benny Hill was
the best. Come on.
And you can catch a little nudity on Benny
Hill. That's true. Right. Yeah.
Benny Hill was a good jack-off show. He was 13, 12.
He was a good jack-off.
Tell niggas who still jag off right when you nutting, post some real warm water on your dick while you nutting. God damn it, it's the most amazing feeling in the world, nigga.
Fuck around him and really fuck yourself up.
No, you can't put real hot water. You'll hurt your skull, your dick. But real warm water. Why you nutting? Put the warm water on your dick and then be like, this nigga is on to something.
What the fuck?
I know, man.
A bit more than Luke.
Back when I used to jag off a lot, I got creative. Right when I was getting ready to nut, I was like, shoot, really? Better than that motherfucker on that 7-Up commercial. I used to be like, ha, 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 ha. You like that, Cody?
Oh, my God.
That's diabolical laugh. That laugh right there sounds diabolical.
Hey.
Oh!
I'm fucking with you, D. I can have a diabolical laugh, though. That's just,
Exactly. Stop getting hostile when I say something. Goodness sake.
Okay, Corey be in the tub with a bow.
Oh.
No, if you already hot, it ain't the same. The hot, it's got to be like a dick shocking warm. Is that a dick shocking warm?
That sounds like too much work, though, Corey.
Dick
you have
shockingly
to check the temperatures
warm.
And all that.
You just start when you're getting close to nothing, you turn the water on. If you got that bullshit sink, you got to motherfucking measure it out with the two water cold.
Corey Ray Cyrus.
Corey Ray
Cyrus.
Oh, my God.
Sticky palms Holcomb.
Yeah.
Hey, man, let me tell you something. Sometimes nut has to be scrubbed off, goddammit. Some of that nut don't want to let go, especially when it get connected on that hair.
Okay.
Yeah, he gets way too. Yeah.
What? I'm trying to put y'all up on game. Niggas being scared. Look, it ain't coy if you explore your own body. Not with no toys, though. Goddammit. If you use a toy, goddammit, you violate yourself. But just different shit to help you relax.
What do you mean violating yourself? Women too?
If you live with a woman and you've been arguing with her, yeah. You gotta learn how to relax yourself. What's your tricks? What you do?
I don't reveal that, Corey.
That's not fair that you keep all the tricks to yourself. People want to know. It's people out here like you have classes where you teach
you might
people
be
how
educating
to do
some
shit.
Young women.
Some people can't think of the shit that other people think of.
Okay, well if they ever want
to
know,
what do you
I
do? You pour hot water on your head after you get
privately.
The shaving?
Oh,
I couldn't help it. I tried. Fuck y'all. He's like, Chris, come breathe on my head after I get this last respect on him. Oh, I could have just had you blow
exactly.
the hair off my
tell
head.
Him, Chris. I could have had Chris. You
blow the hair off my head. Goddamn. A heat shaver.
Right. Goddamn it.
You know what?
Godzilla shave.
Oh. Godzilla shave.
And by the movements of his lips, he can
somebody
make
it. Somebody say Corey playing with his balls. Sharp. I don't play
yeah,
with his
that's
balls.
Yeah, that's exactly.
Forget about the uh-huh. balls. It's Twizzler the head. It's the head that I focus on. Have you ever looked at yourself, like when you jag off, fellas, all you fellas who jag off, go to the store, get a little microscope or the little magnifying glass, and while you nothing, look at your dickhead. When you look at your dickhead under the magnifying glass, your dick be like, shit, nigga, get us blood.
What is going on?
I don't know.
Your dick be like Ted Ross when they killed the Wicked Witch. Everybody look up, because the sun is shining dead on you.
Can't you feel a brand new day?
With the microscope.
I don't know.
Come on, well.
Remember Michael Jackson said that?
Why do you need a magnifier, though, to look at it?
If you get a magnifier, you can look at the real pulsations. Hey man, is that a word?
Are y'all saying magnifier? You niggas said, look at a magnifier.
That's what I'm saying.
It don't have a sun beaming on it.
Yeah, well, then I said, why does he need one?
He's magnifying.
I need a magnifier because I can't see it without the magnifier. Why you don't tell your shit? What kind of freaky shit you got going on when you by yourself?
It's for me to know. Pisces,
so
it's for me to know.
Pisces? What does that mean?
Pisces girl.
Oh,
Pisces
you're talking about the
motherfucker.
Pisces girls?
Yeah.
How do you know this Pisces that's freaky?
Every Pisces I ever met, freaky than a motherfucker.
I never know if a bitch of Pisces. I'm around her for such a short amount of time.
You gotta, it doesn't even matter that Corey could probably
never peace outies, bitch.
Oh,
peace outies?
Peace outies, bitch. That's what I am. I'm a peace outie.
Oh, God.
See, somebody says, shh, don't tell them. Don't tell them. Pisces women?
That's a nigga. That's the gay mayor talking to you.
Oh, God. See, boy, you see? Okay, now he after you, though. Okay.
God damn it.
What? Right. I'm fucking with people. I go in on everybody.
All right.
Thick ass ghetto detective over here fucking with this.
Somebody say you jag off playing bingo, D.
That sounds like fun.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah, I like bingo. Mm-hmm.
Bingo?
What?
Is there a bingo set sold this Christmas? Can we Google that?
No, I have bingo sets. What
you
talking about? I
play
bingo. Yeah, I play all the time. Yeah.
You got a bingo
wheel.
Set?
Yeah.
Wheel.
Got a wheel and everything. It's very professional. It's got the wood lineup.
Tonight
with the...
I'm going to find a Target or something that's still open and see can I find that game Battleship and just play by
oh, they
myself.
Got it. Yep, Battleship.
Battleship is still out.
He's talking about Battleship.
Uh-huh.
Them bullshit ass games. Twister is fun to play to break the ice with a bitch that come to your house. You just gotta hope her feet don't stink.
Oh.
Play Twister with a funky foot bitch. You ain't calling her no more.
Let's stop playing.
You play Jenga with Corey. You play Jenga with Corey. Corey's gonna hit it. He's one of those sore losers. You're playing Jenga and you're still standing. He probably
Jenga. You know what Jenga is?
You know the building, the one. Yeah, that's fun with a lot of people.
Jenga.
J-E-N-G-A.
Did you correct her, though?
I don't know.
No, he don't. He's asking.
Have you ever heard of Jenga?
Is it Jenga or Jenga?
Either or, yeah. Jenga or Jenga. It's J.
Which one is it, y'all?
It's J-E-N-G-A. Jenga.
I thought it was Jenga. Would it be? But I don't know. Shit,
I'm playing. It's the Jenga.
Mm-hmm.
Jenga.
Not
that's
Jenga.
Jamie Foxx character.
It's the Jenga.
Cut it out. Damn it.
Fuck y'all, man. These motherfuckers said some evil shit up here. And I don't look like no inspector, nigga. Somebody say Darlene can play with this Jenga.
Oh.
Jang Lang.
Don't go deeper.
Corn chips.
Anyway.
Yeah. Anyway.
So, Once again, I want to reiterate. Is that the word?
Reiterate.
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 No.
He don't give a fuck. He's just asking.
Reinigorate.
Reinigorate.
I want to reinigorate. Mm-hmm. Hey, y'all, I want to see my flyer on your page and then send it to my Twitter, and I'm going to send it off on my Twitter.
Oh, yeah.
Is it going to be a winner, or are you gonna, what are you going to do? How are you going to do that?
I don't know if it's going to be a winner, but I reach out to people on Twitter.
Are you going to pick a favorite date? Yeah, what's the date for your show?
Look, I'm going to make sure I
did they look it up?
Because, hey,
January
Gooch.
January 29th, right?
Gooch wants 29th. To know. He wants to know. Gooch said he's going to make some flyers. So if Gooch is watching.
Do you have the information on your social media and they can look it up?
Oh, I'm going to post it. Okay. We got to make the flyer tonight, goddammit. So my man out there in Boston, Boston Joe, I need your help, boy. Help me promote this motherfucker. We try to get this bitch. Chris Ackett. And on top of that, the show going to be dope.
The show gonna be dope.
I mean, like, one thing about my shows is like I can't brag, but I know I'm doing something different. I can tell by the shock in the motherfucking weak face. They be like, did this nigga just say? But it's the 29th. On the 29th of January, Boston, Wilbur Theater.
Wilbur Two Theater. Shows. 29th of January.
Yeah.
Boston, Mass.
If you look on the Wilbur. W-I-L-B-U-R, Wilbur website. Mm-hmm. You can find the shows. Nobody's ever thought of doing this. I felt good about it. I was like, because I'm telling you, man, it's some clever motherfuckers with that, whatever that shit, whatever that, what's the app they use to make flyers and shit? The flyer app?
Photoshop,
whatever the fuck. Mm. Motherfuckers make it out of all kind of shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Make your flyer, send it to Corey. How do they send it to you? Where are they sending
they
it?
They post it up where?
Corey Holcomb.
Well, send it to your Twitter or
That's me on Instagram, yeah. And my Facebook is Corey Holcomb. I don't know.
It'd be easy on Twitter, yeah, to get it.
Twitter. Yeah.
What's the page here, Chris?
We don't have one.
No, I'm talking about like CoreyHolcomb.com.
The email,
yeah.
Yeah,
just go to CHolcomb5150show@gmail.
CHolcomb5150show@gmail. That's getting directly in touch with Chris. That's where you send your music shit to.
Yeah.
Cause everybody, I'm not ignoring you, but it's like that shit get flooded with music shit. Hey Corey, listen to this. I listen to some of the shit though. You know what I'm saying? I just can't listen to it all.
What's the email again?
CHolcomb5150show@gmail.
CHolcomb5150show@gmail.
Yeah. I love you too. That's so sweet.
Corey making up words like Stephen A. Smith.
That's a good one.
Corey Inspector Snack It.
We've actually been snacking more than you. Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah, that's the Wilbur Theater. Yeah.
Somebody said this static needs a shout out.
Oh, that's funny.
Damn.
Oh.
What's the static?
The static that you're listening to.
The static that they hear, I guess. It's back.
They said you stole your hat from Detective Finn on Law and Order. On his Oh, okay, you know what?
Fuck with y'all. My hat's sexy, goddammit. Bosalino in the house, motherfucker.
Stole
look
that.
Up Bosalino hats.
Stole that
and
from Shaquille O'Neal.
You put one in layaway. Mm-hmm. I ain't stole shit from Shaq. Shaq.
Shaq, how you think your hat? I know you're dating Corey because my hat is big than a motherfucker.
Because your what?
My hat is big as a motherfucker.
You think his head is bigger than Corey's head?
Are you? I have a village living in my head.
Hey man, look, dog. Shaq had on his little Shaq orthopedic shoes on Wildin' Out.
Shoes look like coffee table.
Right. He had on these Shaq Jordans. Some Shaqs that look like Jordans, dog. Yeah. D-Ray was riding the motherfucker hard on Wildin' Out. We filming Wildin' out here this year in L.A. We coming back to L.A. Nick is not doing it in New York no more, at least not this year.
Mm-hmm.
So we gonna be in L.A. acting a motherfucking fool. I just gonna feel good to film that shit in the motherfucking place where it ain't wintertime.
Okay.
Cause goddamn it, we be in New York. It was goddamn, especially this past year. Goddamn it, it was All Star Weekend. Boy, it was cold.
The Hawk, huh?
Motherfucker. Mm. That 0 degrees shit.
Good, and then D-Ray will still be here, so I can go to the improv.
Yeah, improv on
Mondays.
Mm-hmm. D-Ray do. Well, I ain't, fuck it, man.
You know he's so stupid.
What?
I don't know, just your...
You just laughing because Chris laughing and shit. Oh. Chris, laugh her way.
Laugh her way? What did you...
Boy, okay.
I'm talking about Chris. Now you getting mad anyway.
Nobody's getting mad. I love when you try to say somebody's getting mad. It's like you find joy out of that. There it is. There's the diabolical laugh. I know. Where's he going to be at this weekend?
I'm going to D.C. this weekend, man. We got two big shows at the... Fuck, I forgot the name of that little puss-ass theater.
That's what he gets.
We're going to be at the Warner Theater in D.C. for two big shows. Me, the homegirl Dominique, who played my baby mama on Black Jesus.
The one that Shalinka. Beat your ass.
Yeah, Shalinka. That's the homegirl Dominique. That's the homie.
She beat everybody's ass. She kicked Jesus' ass, too.
Yeah, she beat up everybody, goddammit. Yeah, they got Dominique badass. The little girl who played my daughter on the show, you know, every once in a while they have her and shit. I met her mama, I tried to smash. But I'm saying, I was fucked up. You can't fuck people at the movie set and shit because you got to see them again, goddammit. You be having to act with them, and then what if you can't stand their ass? You know, man, about to fuck the whole season up.
Only Corey. Yeah. What? Okay.
What's wrong with D?
No. Maybe something wrong with me. You're over here. You keep snapping.
I don't think D got that time no more.
Yeah. You know what? Okay. All right. You too, huh?
Salmon ain't swimming upstream no more.
What are you talking about?
Oh, come on.
That thing is always ready. What? The older women I fuck with, I'll be like, baby, let's do it.
You talking about 60s, 70s. You ain't talking about
older. Let me put my cold cream on my elbows.
You bruised them last time.
What's the sounds of elderly bitches while you fucking them?
Oh. No.
All right, now.
Cool out, I'm an old bird, motherfucker.
You ain't got to prove all that.
Lick the geritol out this motherfucker.
No, freeze at the sound. That sounds too funny.
God, you know I need some Bengay now.
This nigga said, lick the geritol out this motherfucker. God damn.
slow down, baby. We're hitting it.
What's the rush?
This shit been here for 70 years. You ain't got to rush nothing.
Then I get this nigga in my stomach for real. Ain't that to block it?
No, I ain't got no uterus.
This one.
Oh, God.
This is the one.
Baby.
Suck this soft ass foot, nigga.
He done started it now, nigga.
Everybody sounds like Della Reese when she got pinky toe.
Shit.
Oh, shit.
Oh, God.
What about old niggas fucking?
I'm coming. Watch out. Hold on.
To have my apple juice ready.
Ease up now. Hold on.
I'm going to do it from the back.
But let's get over here by this wall so I can hold on.
Man. I'm sleeping now, bitch.
I'll pay you in the morning.
Oh, my God.
Suck it to me.
Get off me, bitch.
Ronan.
You are moving and grooving now.
What the old Jamaican niggas say? Make me some porridge.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
you know, how to treat a man righteously. Why, you're better than dumplings in the morning. Well, now, girl. Well, eyes and old man, now you can't kill eyes.
No.
Oh, my God.
Put this keg of water on your way. Real men drink water.
Give me 10 minutes now. Let me get a little sip of water and I'll be back in there. No.
Go outside and smoke the square and come back in there and fuck the shit out of you.
Oh, I'll show you why they call this t-shirt a wife beater.
I'm gonna beat my wife good tonight, goddamn.
Oh, God.
No.
Damn it, my face hurts.
Oh, shit. Okay.
My hip do hurt, though, for real.
That's what he gets.
I'm getting older. My hip was hurting and shit when I was trying to do some...
That's from that running with the raccoon still.
What, you mean when I got hurt on the bike?
When you ran over that raccoon?
That shit really did. It fucked me up.
I remember. You were walking. See?
Look, my wrist hurt. Look, I feel it.
Ooh.
Cause I landed, this wrist hit the ground first. While I was in the air, I was like, "Nigga, I'm about to hit the ground hard."
On your all your weight going to your wrist.
You know
this
what?
Wrist right here, nigga.
Uh-oh. Yeah, it's
this
like
wrist.
Dead.
This wrist stronger than them. This wrist stronger than
he set you up.
Stronger than them spaghetti straps on Aretha Franklin dress. Who said her shit made out of that Wonder Woman rope?
Oh, who said that?
No.
Who said that? That shit, I was dying. They say that's some strong ass them spaghetti straps on Aretha Franklin dress.
They got to hold on the titty.
Hey, no, but she lost a bunch of weight.
Yeah,
now.
Yeah, she did now.
She needed to. Mm-hmm. She needed to.
Mm-hmm. The doctor said I had to, baby.
You'll eat that pussy from the back for $1,000. Off the, just here, thousand, no, just lick and put it in the back 2 minutes.
Zoe, wait. Zoe will eat it for a cheese and cracker.
She's beautiful.
First, hold on now.
Aretha Franklin.
I would not.
You wouldn't eat that pussy from the back.
No.
Aretha Franklin.
Dead in her eye and eat it. I'm showing respect. Beautiful woman like never the respect. I'd peek out up from underneath that belly and say, Aretha, you're beautiful. Go back
in. You gotta open up all that thigh meat rub burn shit.
Now you know she smells like your favorite lunch.
Whoa, that is messed up.
Aretha Zoe going in. Aretha Franklin.
No, I thought I was beautiful.
Smell like some.
Okay.
Blues Brothers Aretha could get it though.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Young Aretha was bad.
Blues Brothers Aretha could get it.
Y'all gonna tell me young Aretha wasn't bad?
She was.
There's a lot of girls bad. Who was young who was bad.
I'm just saying. Old Aretha is, oof.
Eartha Kitt.
Who didn't age well?
Men too. Come
Eartha
on now.
Eartha Kitt.
Men too.
Yeah. Eartha Kitt?
Yeah.
Who's that? Marcus? That bitch?
Yeah.
When she was young, she was bad.
She was bad?
Yeah. Nigga, you remember her Catwoman? Do you remember her as
Catwoman?
Oh,
yeah, she was Catwoman.
Watch Batman,
Catwoman.
Nigga.
She was bad.
Why? You didn't watch Batman when you were younger? You watched everything else.
I watched Jerry Lewis. It's moist there.
You know what?
You didn't watch Batman.
You didn't watch Batman at all. The show, the TV show.
No, I heard Batman.
The vocabulary on the Batman show alone, you should have watched it.
I heard they was trying to fuck each other.
Oh,
I heard Batman
yeah,
and Robin.
Here we go. And you were concerned back then?
Yeah,
was a
my
kid.
Daddy put me on that shit. Tight wearing motherfuckers off my TV. Fuck a Superman, all them motherfucking moist motherfuckers.
Now. Put Kojak on.
Right.
Ironside.
Yeah. Hey, I used to watch
The Rockford Files.
Eddie's courtship.
People let me tell you
about my best friend.
Dantana.
Ooh.
Dantana. Heart to Heart.
Yeah, they were bad.
That nigga used to kill them hoes, for real.
Very funny, Corey.
Yeah,
that's why he had his TV show made after that. He got away with killing that bitch over there on that island.
Oh, yeah.
Tired of you, bitch. Drown.
That's terrible. All right. Oh, God.
What about Three's Company?
Come and knock on this whore.
You know what?
She's been waiting for you.
Yeah, man. For you.
Did you watch Mork and Mindy?
Yeah, I used to watch Mork.
Too Close for Comfort.
Mm-hmm. It's a living.
It was one of them shows. Which was the one? Was the one with Schneider?
The Facts of Dykes. Yeah.
No.
You know what? No.
Diner. Alice.
Not Alice.
There's Males
no,
Diner?
No, Schneider was the janitor. He's
Yeah.
And the chicks, the girls used to always have camel toes on that show.
What was that shit?
There was some fat monkeys on TV back then, this boy.
Is it?
I heard Thelma used to have a camel toe.
What was the name of Good that Time? Show?
Yeah.
Show. I worked with Thelma.
Yeah, it was the Two Daughters and a Single Mom.
Schneider was the building.
Homegirl started doing drugs on that show, she said. Remember?
Knocking the mom, remember?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, Soap was always a dope one, too, though.
I couldn't watch Soap. That shit, I couldn't get into
this motherfucker said one day at a time.
One day at a time. There it is. That was it. Yeah.
That was the show.
He said Camel Toe Ring.
What about
Maude,
that deep voice bitch?
With Maude?
Maude? Oh, yeah,
would
she
you
was
bring
good.
Me a pack of Newports?
MacGyver was the shit.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Why you bullshit?
I remember on one of the Cosby Show cartoons.
Trash in here and make a car out of it, nigga.
Remember that dude got killed on the Cosby Show cartoon?
No,
the Cosby Show cartoon. It was that one cartoon.
You talking about Fat Albert?
Yeah, Fat Albert. That one dude got killed on the show. They showed a dude get killed and shit. And they had that song they was playing in the junkyard.
Yeah, got you gone. We gonna miss you, Ronald.
Ronald.
Probably Ronald.
This ain't them bullshit songs. I like them songs back in the day.
Man.
It takes two to do it right.
Yeah, very good. Yeah.
Oh, I used to watch Alf too.
Oh, yeah,
Alf was
yeah.
The shit. Alf. He used to go in on motherfuckers.
Married with
but Sanford and Son, come on, man. They came in and just killed it.
Legendary.
I mean, my mama had on TV and shit, and I saw a porno dog. My dick was so hard that night when I
this
went
this is what
to
happened
sleep.
To him. He was scarred. He's had so many
boy, when you about motherfucking 8 years old and you see some
wait,
people
that
fucking.
And that wasn't the thing where you saw the lady's pubic hair in the exercise outfit.
That's when they
outfit.
Had the nappy ass taco meat pubic hair.
And that's why he's
I remember
he's
that
like,
lady. I couldn't even sleep. I didn't know what to do. I wanted to touch it so bad.
Oh my God. What the hell?
That pubic hair looked so good. I was changed as a young man, dog.
Oh, nigga.
He's scarred.
Silver spoons.
Silver spoons together.
Oh, yeah, with Ricky Schroeder.
Yeah.
He was a kid child actor. He survived the game.
Excellent.
Ricky Schroeder,
spoons,
yeah.
Man. Koi spoons. That's the new fuck it.
Anyway, all right.
We're going to wrap this little pussy shit up. 5150 has lived another week. We are in the process of trying to get the fuck out of this studio or room or whatever you want to call it. We got a landlord issue.
We in a hotel room right now, y'all.
God damn it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We've done it out of a hotel room
Benji,
before.
That I remember. Was
back when we
too.
Had
I
the
like
little
that,
homegirl
yeah.
on the show.
Claudia.
No, yeah, Claudia came periscoping and shit.
That was before Periscope.
Right. Well, what did she have? She was YouTubing. Uscopia.
Wait, whoa.
Uscopia. YouTube.
He just
Uscopia.
Made up his own thing.
Uscopia. Right, goddammit. Claudia, where you at, goddammit? I'll be glad when she fall off all the way so she'll be trying to get this little 200 I'm offering.
You know what? Oh my God.
No, you know you need it now. Fuck pride. Look what pride got you.
She doing pretty good for herself right now.
I know. That's the worst shit. Girls who doing good for themselves, goddammit. Hate that shit. You don't need me now. Don't last forever, bro.
That's all right. Right. You'll be back.
Oh. Anyway, yeah. Anybody got anything they want to plug before we get the fuck up out of here? Because I want to tell you something. We got some new shirts coming out. We're going to have a specially made shirts for that week in Boston.
Right.
Oh.
God damn it. So.
Excellent.
You know what I'm saying?
They can buy them before the show then?
They can
through
buy
the
them
website?
Before the show and wear them to the show in the audience. Mm. Or we're going to be selling them at the show.
I'm going to say this. Support Corey on the 29th. You got to be out there in force. Support Corey on the 29th. Purchase my book. Go get Darlene's book.
Yes.
Right?
Yep.
You can get it on Amazon, Kindle version, or you can get the physical copy.
Mm-hmm.
Go to my website, iamzoewilliams.com. and purchase a copy of the book.
And also, Freeze dressed like he drive a snowplow.
That's right, Wally Delaney.
Oh, that's right. And download the Zoe Williams app. If you're an Android user or an Apple user, it's on both platforms. Find the app by typing in Zoe Williams, no spaces, Z-O Williams. Download the app. You can find out everything that I'm doing, shows. It gives you notifications, everything. It's a pretty dope app. Oh, and by the way, on the 29th, while you in Boston, I'm going to be at Kentucky State University doing a lecture there. So just come out and check me out there, too.
Oh, yeah. Goddamn, nice. If you're on that side of the region, goddammit, fuck with my man Zoe.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It is what it is, man. Mm-hmm. We gonna put our shit out there, and you know what I'm saying? Once I get this new studio, I'm gonna be selling commercial time.
Oh, yeah.
To try to motherfucking pay for some of this shit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I ain't knocking nobody upside the head. Just, mm-hmm. you know.
A little something.
Donate this, pass me this, and then we gonna advertise your shit.
There you go. There it is.
Up to what, Chris? How many motherfuckers?
5 million.
5 million motherfuckers?
YouTube views, yeah. It is.
Somebody like this shit.
You know what
I'm saying? And all you motherfuckers who won't subscribe, you bogus for that.
Subscribe.
Subscribe so I can motherfucking try to turn it into some shit. Don't y'all want to see me on TV and get ran off TV?
Don't you want to see Corey like in a tutu?
Corey ain't going to be in no tutu, goddammit. I'm not from Country Club Hill. I'm from motherfucking Chicago, nigga.
Look at that nigga's face. Where you from?
From motherfucking Chicago. God damn it. Mm. You dig what I'm saying? I ain't one of them look suburban ass sugar booger sniffing ass nigga.
Oh, these niggas said I was in the Rhythm Nation. They talked about my shirt.
They said they saw Mary J. Blige.
They called me the golden child.
God damn it. This thing got built-in tassels on that motherfucker.
Hey, man. This is Marcus Garvey, man.
Oh, it is.
That's Marcus Garvey?
This is Marcus Garvey.
Who's that?
That
look like Eazy-E. Don't play yourself. Here it does. Look, look.
You
right
don't look
here.
Like that's because your eyes is bad. This is Marcus Garvey, goddamn. Put your shades on and look
from
at this
here.
Shit.
I thought that was Clayton
does.
Thomas, nigga.
Marcus Garvey, pimp.
That's true. Yeah, look.
I don't know what she was. Caesar's dealer's jacket. I'm buying
you
that shit. Paul Bunyan over here.
Don't look, Freeze look like he about to do honky tonk radio. All right, motherfuckers. Right.
Look at Freeze. Freeze look like he didn't like that.
Hey, nah.
Freeze back then.
Freeze is signifying. We go in, nigga. Freeze sitting there thinking of a way to get me back.
I'm just looking at your Howard the Duck hat, nigga.
Yeah.
All right, well, hey, nigga. Hey, nigga, look. Thank y'all for tuning in, motherfucker. Tune in next week. We up out this bitch. Chris, blow us off.